where they are taking on the Delaware Thunder. We want to welcome everyone into the broadcast. Thank you so much for joining us for Sunday afternoon hockey. The Delaware Thunder, just 4 wins on the season, but they got one of them against the River Dragons on Friday, compared to 30 losses and 2 points past regulation. But Columbus has clinched a postseason berth. That's right. The Commissioner's Cup is in sight for the River Dragons, and they are the first team in the Continental Division to clinch a postseason spot. They do so with the win last night, 9-0, on a sold-out night here at the Columbus Civic Center. It was the first ever sellout in River Dragons history, and the River Dragons very happy. It kind of harkened back a little bit, if you've been a Columbus hockey fan for a long time, to the heydays of the Cottonmouths a little bit. Fantastic showing last night, and the River Dragons absolutely exploded offensively, led by 4 goals and an assist from Thomas Aldworth. We'll hear from him in our first period intermission. The River Dragons just poured it all out there yesterday. A tremendous game and a great comeback after losing in a shootout on Friday night to Delaware. So the River Dragons hope to keep that ball rolling for themselves here today and really try to put things in perspective down the stretch. There's less than 2 months left in the season now. Columbus, the games are ticking down. You're starting to face those opponents that are really going to matter here. Carolina is still on the schedule 4 times. We're going to see Binghamton 3 times, yet we have not at all seen the Binghamton Black Bears. In fact, that's the last team in the league Columbus has not faced at home or on the road. One of the unique things about the schedule is this is the second to last 3-3. Next weekend, there's only one game on the docket for the River Dragons. That is a Friday game, and then they have the weekend off as they travel to Mississippi one final time to check out the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's still work to do. Here is the River Dragons wearing their teal jerseys on a Sunday matinee. We've got a little afternoon hockey for you. Hope you stay tuned with us. Here is the River Dragons and the Delaware Thunder going head-to-head just a little less than a half hour from now. There are still plenty of seats available here for this afternoon's game. If you want to come down and join us, we'd love to have you at the Civic Center. And it is your last chance to see the Delaware Thunder during the regular season. These two teams will meet again, but it'll be up north. So if you want to see the Thunder in person, this is your last chance to come down. Plenty to get to in our Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We have our chat with head coach Jerome Bichard. We'll have a look around the Zelmo Zippin out-of-town scoreboard. And if you're a race fan, we'll update you on what's going on to the Daytona 500 as well. Stick around. There's more coming your way in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, we're excited to be able to offer you our special $69 tune-up offer. With an Air Force tune-up, a certified and trained technician will perform a comprehensive inspection and duct inspection. This can help reduce utility costs and prevent costly repairs. Schedule your tune-up today. Call 706-813-1935. We're always here when you need us, Air Force Heating and Air.
River Dragons hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like chuck-a-pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
At the Country Inn & Suites by Radisson, you'll enjoy comfortable accommodations close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons. Country Inn & Suites by Radisson.
At Mr. Sparky, we're America's on-time electrician. We all count on our home's electrical outlets to provide us the power we need when we need it. But sometimes an overloaded circuit can lead to a blown outlet. So leave it to the pros at Mr. Sparky. We'll get it done right and get it done safely. Call now for $50 off electrical repairs.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Limitations and restrictions may apply. Independently owned and operated. Licensed in the respective state or county.
I love the way they all doubt me. That's the energy.
And we are back here at the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan here with you as we're getting ready to go. The River Dragons taking on the Delaware Thunder for the final time at home this season, and warm-ups finishing up. A little bit of housekeeping for you as the River Dragons have re-signed goaltender Ty Hunter back to the roster, and Hunter is slated to back up here in this afternoon's game as the River Dragons, again, a little bit of a rare Sunday matinee effort, but all the same, it's still fun to play. And in a way, it's a difference, not only from a start time perspective, but in preparation. Most teams at any level do not skate in the morning unless it is players not dressing when there is an afternoon game, and even a little bit later start like this, they might come in or get a little workout, whether on their own or here at the rink, try to get things ready for themselves and mentally prepare for the game. And the River Dragons, no exception to that. In Delaware, also coming to the rink a couple hours before game time and then just getting ready for the drop of the puck here. And right now, the River Dragons finishing up their warm-up portion of the program. Delaware as well. And for the Columbus River Dragons here, as I mentioned, that little roster note that Hunter is back, signed to the squad once again today. And, you know, at this level, it can be very hard when you are kind of squeezed because there's no real way. So maybe in the National Hockey League, you can assign a player somewhere. Or in the American League, you can take that player that you really want to keep and loan him or assign him. But at the level, at a level like the FPHL, it's much harder to do. And so what happens is sometimes you will see players who get left off the roster or perhaps are inadvertently, I guess, not even inadvertently, on purpose, put aside because of roster limitations, because of cap limitations, and things of that nature. So the River Dragons were a little squeezed earlier this week and decided to see also if Hunter might have been able to catch on someplace else. And, you know, that's one of the things about Jerome Bichard, the head coach of this team. He wants these guys to do well. And if they're not playing, it was kind of the same story with Rickard Zielinski. So if you remember, Jelly started out hot with the River Dragons earlier this year, then kind of fell back a little bit, really wasn't seeing the playing time, and was out there practicing every day, working hard every day, liked being a part of the team. But sometimes you have the conversation with the player, and if you can be moved as a player to a situation where you have more playing time, more ability to make an impact, perhaps that appeals to you. And I think that that's what the case was with Zielinski's, is that the River Dragons are able to move him to Elmira, where he is able to play more, he's able to see more ice, and, you know, perhaps he catches fire, maybe he just figures things out for North America. It's not always easy to make an adjustment coming over, but you give that player a chance, and I think that that is very admirable for the way the River Dragons comport themselves as an organization. They're not beholden to trying to hold guys back or say, oh, well, I'd really selfishly like to keep this player, because clearly, Zielinski's is a talented guy with a killer shot. But, again, I mean, everybody would handle it differently. But the River Dragons opting to say to a player like that, hey, if you want to try to go someplace else and latch on, let's see if we can't do that for you to help you, to further your career and help you enjoy still playing this game instead of driving a player maybe into an early retirement sometimes, which at this level I think happens a lot and probably happens more than it should. So that was the case with Hunter earlier this week. He is back on the roster, and as I mentioned, he will be on the squad for today's game as the River Dragons and the Thunder going back at it one more time here. And boy, I just want to go back and comment again on last night. If you don't know what happened, the River Dragons sold out the building for the first time in franchise history. Now, not the first time in Columbus hockey history. Certainly back in the heyday of the Cottonmouths, this building was packed and rocking on a regular basis. And the River Dragons are trying to establish themselves as well in the hockey community here. And I think last night shows that they are well on their way to doing so. And I also know that, boy, when you have a game like that, it is absolutely necessary to perform. And Columbus did. The River Dragons ended up with a 9-0 victory. That was a tremendous game for Columbus yesterday. And they did it in all ways, even strength, shorthanded, power play. They were just all over. As a matter of fact, they scored twice in the power play yesterday in five chances and moved up to fifth on the power play in the FPHL. So that was a really nice jump. As now they're up to 17.6%, which, believe it or not, is a three-way tie with Elmira and Mississippi for power play, but now they're within striking distance of that top four. On the other hand, their penalty kill again coming through, and 87.8%, that is tops in the league. And the River Dragons, at this point of the season, to be so close to 90% is unbelievable in the special teams battle. And so the River Dragons really, as I mentioned, they did it all ways yesterday, and nine goals. Certainly we thank all the men and women in the armed forces who were out here yesterday, veterans, active duty. The energy was incredible in the building. And that's something that I think the River Dragons are going to be able to accomplish more often down the road here and in the future. And bringing more people to games is what it's all about. I am a big proponent of hockey is for everyone, that there are no non-traditional markets. There are only hockey markets. And if you like the game, you didn't have to grow up with the game to love it. I think we're seeing that. And, you know, talking with some of the fans even today about their experience and how they got into hockey. Not everybody was born with it. Some fans, and I know we have the Daytona 500 going on today, some fans were NASCAR fans, some fans were baseball, certainly with the Braves here. College football is very important. This is big-time SEC country. A little bit of the ACC if you happen to be Georgia Tech. I don't want to forget about you. But, you know, it's an important part of the culture here in the Chattahoochee Valley is to have that sports component to it. And I really think that the River Dragons are very thankful to be a part of it and also really appreciate the support they get from their fans and their sponsors right here in the Chattahoochee Valley. Let's take a break. When we come back, we'll take a look at the Zelmos Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard. There are a couple games in the FPHL today, also the NHL. Plus, again, as I said, we will update you on the Daytona 500 if you are a fan of the race. And if you don't want to know what's going on, don't worry, I'll give you the heads up. And if you're DVRing it at home, you can cover your ears and you won't miss the thing. All right, let's come back with more in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call 706-324-6661.
Hey sports fans, the seasons are changing and it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Call Air Force Heating and Air today for our special $69 tune-up offer. With an Air Force tune-up, a certified and trained technician will perform a comprehensive inspection and duct inspection. This can help reduce utility costs and prevent costly repairs. Schedule your tune-up today. Call 706-223-1945. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air.
Craving a burrito, some nachos, or maybe even a quesadilla? Head to Barberitos. Their menu includes only the freshest ingredients, and your order is custom-made how you want it on the spot. Barberitos is founded on freshness, and everything from our handmade guacamole to our marinades are made right in-house. And don't forget, you can order online at Barberitos.com or through our handy mobile app. Barberitos. Food. Community. People.
While the River Dragons handle pests on the ice, Orkin takes care of rodents and pests at your home or business. Locally owned and operated, Orkin creates a custom pest plan specifically for you. Orkin can help eliminate and control mice, bed bugs, ants, roaches, stinging insects, and cockroaches, just to name a few. Remember, they're not happy until you're happy, so visit Orkin.com for a free estimate and trust the only pest control service the Dragons trust, Orkin. Now, if they could just control seawolves and thunderbirds...
And we're back here at the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan here with you, the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Thank you so much for joining us as we are awaiting the start of today's action between the Delaware Thunder and the Columbus River Dragons. And in a moment, we're going to take a look at our Zelmo's Zipping Out of Town scoreboard as the River Dragons here getting set to try to make it 2 out of 3 on the weekend. Maybe 2.5 out of 3. They did get a point for the shootout, but last night clinching a spot in the postseason. If you're just joining us, you might have missed that news. Yes, indeed, with the 3-point win yesterday, the River Dragons end up with that postseason berth. Now clinched, but the work is not done. And certainly that's one of the things that I like about this locker room is there is a lot of knowledge that, hey, there's much more to do here. In fact, looking at it from a standpoint of this team really wants to not only win a division title, but they also want to win a league title. And then they want to win the Commissioner's Cup. And I think that that's absolutely tremendous the way they have it set up for themselves that, you know, there's goals along the way. Okay, so first goal, check. You got to make the playoffs, right, to be able to do these things. The River Dragons are still the best team in the league, and they want to guard that. And coming into today at 29-6-3 with 86 points, they're 4 points in front of Danbury, although Danbury's played one more game. Binghamton's at 78 points. Carolina's at 78 points. Those are the teams you're trying to stay in front of. After that, it kind of falls off. But the Continental Division has proven itself to be tougher than the Empire Division. Port Huron, 64 points. Motor City, 60 points. And it's only Mississippi that's had struggles this year, 27 points. But now if you look over the gap between Binghamton at 78 points in the Empire, Watertown is 38 points behind, 40 points, and then 39 points for Elmira. You may think I'm crazy for saying this, but Delaware has 19 games left. And it is possible that Delaware, if they went on a run and Watertown or Elmira falls apart, Delaware could find a way to jump in there. Remember, every regulation win in this league is worth 3 points, not two. So that gap of 26 points, which seems big, and it is, don't get me wrong, Delaware would have to put in serious work and go on a tear. Is it possible? Absolutely it's possible, especially because Elmira's played one more game than they have. So, you know, you start to chew up those point gaps, and you need help at this point. Don't get me wrong, but the Empire Division has certainly, it's the haves, which is Danbury and Binghamton, and the have-nots. But in the Continental, I think the top four teams going into the playoffs, which seeding right now would be Columbus against Motor City, and then Carolina Port Huron, anybody can beat anybody else. And it's almost a little bit of a shame that Port Huron Motor City wouldn't meet, or you wouldn't think they would meet, in the postseason at that point. I would love to watch a series between those two teams. They just absolutely go at it. But in the meantime, you know, no matter who the road has to go through for the River Dragons, it's not going to be an easy one. And they know that. So, all right, quick look at the Zelmo's Zipping Out of Town scoreboard. There is one other game going on right now. Speaking of Watertown and Elmira, they're it. 1-0 Elmira has a lead. That's about halfway through the second period of that game. NHL going on right now. You got Wild up 3-1 on the Predators in the third period. Halfway through in the third, it's Senators 6-1 over the Blues. And, boy, the Blues have just punted on this season as they start to dismantle that team. They traded Tarasenko, now Ryan O'Reilly to the Leafs. And the Senators taking full advantage of that. Oilers 3-0 over the Avalanche. That's in the second period. Coming up later, you got Leafs at Blackhawks, Jets at Devils, and the Blue Jackets at the Coyotes. We're going to hold off on the Daytona 500 update for you because in the meantime, we got to get out the door. We have a chat with head coach Jerome Bischar coming your way here in just a moment. And on the other side of that, we're going to drop the puck and get it underway here from the Columbus Civic Center. River Dragons and the Thunder this afternoon. Hey, you got nothing else going on? Come on down and join us here at the Civic Center. We've got some great FPHL hockey action coming your way. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Fleet Tire and Service, located at 3109 Victory Drive in Columbus, is the perfect place to take care of everything your vehicle needs. From preventive maintenance to alignments, brakes, oil changes, and more, your friends at Complete Tire and Service have you covered. Need tires? Buy three, get one free for passenger vehicles. Call 706-321-8133 to set up your appointment. 321-8133. Complete Tire and Service on the web at ctstires.com.
HydroLife Therapy in Old Town is your one-stop recovery shop to get you back to 100%. With IV therapy treatments, cryotherapy, and compression therapy all under one roof, HydroLife treatments are packed with nutrients to increase energy and boost your immune system. Join the IV League today for the most affordable way to feel better, look better, and start accomplishing more. Online at HydroLifeTherapy.com/Columbus. HydroLife Therapy. Start living your best life.
Hey, sports fans, it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. As the official air conditioning sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, we're excited to be able to offer you our special $69 tune-up offer. With an Air Force tune-up, a certified and trained technician will perform a comprehensive inspection and duct inspection. This can help reduce utility costs and prevent costly repairs. Schedule your tune-up today. Call 706-813-1935. We're always here when you need us, Air Force Heating and Air.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled-to-perfection burger sounds amazing, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang, burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavors makes every bite of lettuce, every sesame seed on the bun, and every sip of that crisp, refreshing, ice-cold cola a journey to Foodtopia. Burgers, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Welcome back to the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We're joined by head coach Jerome Bichard. Coach, wow, what a game last night. What an atmosphere. Let's talk first about the first ever sellout in River Dragons history. What was it like being a part of that?
Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen one of those. You know what? The atmosphere was electric. Obviously, the troops, they're awesome. Goosebumps when they stand up and do their creed. You know what? You just cut the emotion with a knife last night in the Civic Center.
And a tremendous response by the River Dragons after that Friday shootout loss. You come out with a big 9-0 win.
Yeah, you know what? Slow start. You know, kind of a lot of the same as Friday night starting off. And, you know, it took us a period to figure out. Kind of went in, and I was like halfway through the second period. I kind of lost my temper a little bit, and I'm like, guys, can you stop the bull crap and let's go play? And prior, the first half, we were kind of circling and we were spread out, and we didn't have a whole lot of puck support. Yes, we had a couple good looks, and then finally they started moving the puck and spreading them out in the offensive zone and shooting the puck from out, not at the hash marks and in the crease, and things just opened up, and we ended up playing the right way the rest of the game.
You know, I think maybe as a nod to that big crowd, everybody wanted to be the guy that made the big play, right, in the beginning, and I think maybe that was part of it.
Yeah, you know what, everybody had the emotions and they were going, and you know, we were running around a little bit trying to create that, and it got us a couple penalties that we didn't need. Kind of hindered us getting into a rhythm in the first period because we were killing penalties and all that. And but you know, we finally figured it out and took control of the game.
Do you feel like Delaware maybe was almost trying to play, I don't know a better term for it, but a quieter game, not poke the bear sort of thing?
You know what? I mean, you got to give them credit. They keep playing. They just come in and play hard, and they're always there. You know, they may not win the battle, they may not this and that, but they're always there. And if we, especially in our defensive zone, if we circle and aren't doing the little things like the hard things, if we play easy, when I say easy, it's I circled, my guy just got rid of the puck, and I circle back and I go re-attack the puck. That's not your job. Your job is to stay with that guy. And we did that a few times in the first period. And Christian Pavlis came up with some really big saves in the first period and throughout the game. You know, when we broke down, he stood tall and made the saves that he needed to.
He also ripped a killer pass up to Allworth on the breakaway.
Yeah. I mean, tape to tape, right up the pipe. I don't think I've ever seen that from a goalie before. So put that in the repertoire for the playoffs type thing. And, you know, we're not really the way we play, that's really not in our repertoires, hitting that stretch guy. But, you know, every now and then you can throw it in there and surprise guys.
Let's wrap it all up with the keys to the game this afternoon against Delaware.
Keys tonight. You know what? I got to challenge my guys to play simple, play smart, play within themselves, and you know, continue to do a little bit of what we did last night at the end, and just pick your spots a little bit better.
All right, Coach, thanks for joining us. Best of luck tonight.
You bet. Thank you.
Back with the drop of the puck in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat press lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
So you've got projects to do around your home. You got Harvey Lumber for that. You've decided to finally get that large deck built in the back for family fun and entertaining like you've been dreaming about for so long. You got Harvey Lumber for that. From replacing a few boards to replacing all the windows to building from the ground up, you've got Harvey Lumber for that. It's kind of like that old saying, there's an app for that. Well, whatever you need in the way of building supplies, there's been a Harvey Lumber for that in the Chattahoochee Valley for over 150 years. Harvey Lumber Company, 815th Street, open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5.
It's time for River Dragons Hockey. Tonight's game is brought to you by Sun South, Hydra Live, Mr. Sparky, Express Printing, BioLife Plasma, Pepsi, Vector Ply, Zelmo's Zip-In, Houston Clinic, Columbus Diagnostic, Kinetic Credit Union, IGH Properties, Trivoli's, Shredaway, Nuke's Eatery, West Georgia Oral and Facial Surgery, Victory Land, Wade Cleaners, and PMB Broadcasting. Now let's start the game with the voice of River Dragons Hockey, Tom Callahan.
Sean Patrick Marion with the anthem before this afternoon's game. Tom Callahan here with you. Thank you so much for joining me here from the Columbus Civic Center as we're getting ready to go for River Dragons hockey. We don't see the teal jerseys too much. Well, that's their Sunday best. And we will have a ceremonial puck drop coming up here momentarily as the River Dragons getting set to go here with the Delaware Thunder. Third and final time you'll see Delaware in town this season. All right, These two teams will rematch in Delaware next month, towards the end of the month. But as we get ready to go here, the River Dragons are going to go head-to-head with Delaware for a critical 3 points. And again, as I mentioned, Delaware not out of the playoff yet. They're not eliminated. However, looking at what could happen for Delaware, they have a lot of work to do if they are going to make the playoffs. They've started to put it together, though. They've won 3 of their last 4 after winning only 1 of their previous, I believe it was 33 games. That's tough. But they're building something in Delaware, and they're trying to get their identity going. They're trying to get this team together. They're trying to pull in a single direction. And this afternoon, I'll tell you what, after you get beat 9-0, your response matters. So let's see what we have here as the River Dragons roll left to right in front of our Harvey Lumber broadcast booth. Puck dumped in, and Colgan will leave it at the side of the net for King. We'll get to the starting goaltenders in just a moment here. Storjahan on the left side with the pass. Kelly has to loop back for it. Kelly put that across for Frazio. Frazio, Storjahan, lead at center. Kelly tips it in, and that one is steered to the corner by Jacob Nedchenko. Puck in behind the net. River Dragons on a big hit on the play. Puck up the slot. Greco kicks it over to Kelly. Little spin move here. Kelly leaves for Greco at the point. Shot off a shin. Finds the left side corner. Turnaround drive and a save there as Petrantonio let it go. Jacob Nedchenko getting the start in net for Delaware. Just one decision on the year. He's 0-1-0 with an .800 save percentage and an 8.03 goals against average. He has appeared in 6 games for the Thunder this year. But getting the spot start here on the weekend after Trevor Martin played Friday and Saturday. Brennan Colgan in net for the River Dragons, 14-4-2. .918 save percentage, 2.31 goals against average, and an FPHL single season record, 6 shutouts. River Dragons blanked Delaware last night 9-0. Christian Pavlos, not only with a shutout, 28 saves, but also an assist. There's a shot from the right point. Mike Greco that finds a glass behind the net. Asp centered. There's a turnover there, and boy, that got right to Doe in the slot, but it looked like the puck was up on edge. Long shot in goes wide. Here's Petrantonio to the near corner. His pass hits a stanchion. Doe in front looking for Underwood, who had 2 last night. Backdoor, Petrantonio off the toe of a stick behind to Doe in front. Underwood tied up. Doe doesn't shoot. Looking. Feeds the left point. LaBelle, right point, Greco. His wrister in. Tipped in front, just wide. Underwood on it. River Dragons are swarming to start here. Petrantonio slowing it up at the point. Tried to leave it, but he left it behind LaBelle, and now 3-on-2 for Delaware. They'll bring it back the other way. Gafarov put it into the slot. Puck still there. He gets it back. His shot blocked. Rebound in front. Save Colgan, and he scissors the pads on it. Oh, that turned into a hairy moment there. Petrantonio wanted a change, and he was carrying the puck up to the blue line. Tried to leave it to LaBelle, but he put it behind him, and then all of a sudden, Petrantonio had to go into defensive mode, and it was already a 3-on-2. Face off to the right of the River Dragons net. Jamath moving it up ahead, and on the left side, here's Aldworth. Jamath, Aldworth, and Wickline playing together here. Here's Aldworth to the right point. Shot coming in by Vanelli. That is kicked out by Nedchenko to the near side. Vanelli holding it in. Puck into the slot. Wickline tried to step through traffic with it. Rogers sending it in deep. Chance in front for Jamath, and he had a stick tied up there by Hanakainen. And Delaware away up the left wing side. The Thunder trying to find a little offense here. Pass goes to the line, and Asp did not get there in time to keep it in. Delaney, I think that was a little bit of a hoper, looking to find somebody. Asp will carry it back in, up by himself. Now he swings it around the wall. Rogers on to the far corner, played back around to Vanelli. Vanelli pokes it ahead to Wickline. Wickline with a lead pass on to the wing. River Dragons attacking Kelly at the line to Storjahan. His shot. Nedchenko, a blocker save. Storjahan swings it around to the right point. Frazio quickly to the left side. Ozlinch into the high slot. King backing up to his left. Wrister, blocker save again. King on it at the far dot. Tied up. Couldn't get his pass away. Kelly off angle. Chance off the crossbar. Frazier at the right point, holding it in. Boy, Kelly got it over the shoulder of the goaltender. It just went post out. Last night, the River Dragons had one go back bar out. At time, it was a controversial goal, made it 1-0, but then the River Dragons poured on eight more. And that one turned into a no-doubter. Kelly up the left side, lead too far ahead for Storjahan, but the return pass a little far for Wilson, and that one all the way down. No icing, though, as Frazier after it. He'll stop back there. On to the left wing side. Here comes Columbus. Greco leading it ahead at center. He'll turn that one in behind the net. Petrantonio with a hit. Turns the puck over. Underwood on the near side. Pinned up in the pile. Now it's taken out of there. Hanakainen trying to clear. Cannot, but it comes over to Houston Wilson. He'll skate it through center. Now onto the left wing side into the River Dragons end. Off angle chance blocked to the glass by the stick of Greco. Around it comes to the near side, and Underwood tied up on the half wall. LaBelle into the pile. Puck free behind. We get a little bit of pushing and shoving, and now, well, here we go. Gafarov, it was challenged by Greco. Or is that? No, LaBelle jumped in there to answer the bell. And they're going to try to exchange some rights here, and now Gafarov got a right in. LaBelle got a big one over the top on him. They continue to tie up here. LaBelle, and he spins him down to the ice. It looked like Denis Gafarov had taken some liberties with Underwood on the near side boards. And it was LaBelle who came over to answer for it. And now Gafarov, who went down to the ice, and it was kind of a product of the odd way they were tied up, but Greco had Gafarov, I don't want to say in a headlock because that's not entirely accurate, he was kind of ducked under his arm, and when they spun down to the ice, Gafarov's forehead hit the ice without his helmet on. Well, he was down for a minute. Hopefully he's okay. They're going to take a look at him on the bench here. So the fireworks carry over from yesterday, where at the end of the game, certainly Delaware showed some frustration. Right now they're over at the bench, still checking on Gafarov. I would imagine they're going to have to put somebody in the box for him in the meantime. He went down to the ice pretty hard. Would not be surprised if he was a little bit more than dazed right now. And indeed, there is medical personnel over there taking a look at him. Of course, every building has doctors and EMTs on staff, and let's see if they let him stay in the game and he sits in the penalty box, or if they bring him off the ice. They are going to take him off the ice. And that's a hard one, but I'm a big player safety proponent, and that is the right move. If they have to check him out, check him out. And I would say that whether it was a River Dragons player or a Thunder player. And you've got too many things outside of hockey to worry about, even players at the NHL level. So 4:25 into the Sun South John Deere first period. Got a couple of fighting majors. So it'll be LaBelle and then whoever serves for the Thunder. Right now in the Civic Center, it's comfortable 72 degrees, but the temperature in your home isn't comfortable. Call Air Force Heating and Air. They have a plan that's right for your home and your budget. Icing against the River Dragons. We are indeed skating at 5-on-5 right now. The River Dragons down a defenseman here. Good to see Alexander Jemayev back in the lineup. He's been battling some bumps and bruises. And he draws back in here on a Sunday. Definitely an offensively talented guy who could put the puck in the net. Happy to see him back into playing shape. Delaware trying to make some things happen here. On the near side wall in the River Dragon zone after winning the faceoff, pushing it into the corner. Grant Mentis up with it, but that one is taken away by Aldworth. He'll go left side. Jemayev curls back with it. There's a lead through center. Puck tipped down. Now Aldworth chasing. He has some help in front, trying to center. That pass hit Hanakainen in the skates. Jemayev after it. Aldworth behind the net. Jemayev has it poked away up the near side boards. Wolf will lift the wedge back out to center. Here's Vanelli on the right side with it. He'll move it ahead. Cutting in Wickline, leaving it Aldworth. Aldworth looking back door. Oh, that one was cut off by Nedchenko. Got a piece of it. And he had Jemayev at the back post, but the pass just didn't quite get through. Net comes off. We get a break. 5:23 into the first. Scoreless between the River Dragons and the Delaware Thunder. We're back with more in a moment. More in a moment.
Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
When it comes to equipment, you don't have to pay more to get more. At SunSouth, we strive to provide the best customer service along with the best equipment. And right now, you can own quality John Deere equipment from SunSouth with 0% interest for 60 months. That's right, 0% interest for 60 months on top models, including John Deere 1 Series, 3 Series, and even 5 Series tractors. For the equipment to meet your needs, visit SunSouth. Equipment for those that do.
Restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires February 28, 2023.
River Dragons Hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like chuck-a-pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
Welcome back to the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan here with you. SunSouth John Deere first period equipment for those that do. It's scoreless between the River Dragons and the Delaware Thunder right now. Nice crowd on hand here, actually, for a Sunday afternoon game. We appreciate everybody being here. On the heels of a sellout last night for Military Appreciation Night. It's been a very good weekend for the River Dragons. And it's pitched in on the right side. Kelly King Storjahan out there. This line hasn't been as active in the last couple of games. Kelly with a shot that goes wide. But, you know, it's nice for Columbus. We'll come back to this. We have a two-on-two the other way. Here comes Delaware moving in. Wrist shot. That one is sent high to the glass. All the way around to the left point. Asp keeping it in. Colgan with a stick save on it. Rebound bouncing side of the goal. Colgan with the left pad down. He's able to freeze it. And, whoop, here we go. Frazier is going to get in there, and he's taking a couple of lefts in there from O'Reilly. As those two spin around, O'Reilly just trying to throw the lefts in. Frazier tying him up. The linesman, it's so thankless to be a linesman. The linesman, I think, took more shots than Frazier did. Frazier never even took his gloves off. O'Reilly just kept throwing. I don't think Frazier wanted any part of him. O'Reilly was trying to get him to go. Frazier's just looking at him like, you gotta be kidding me, dude. I had a good talk with Frazier before the game, especially on the heels of everything that happened to him yesterday. He ended up with a 5-minute cross check and then the game misconduct. And we talked about it today a little bit and just, you know, there's a difference between drawing the line and, you know, when you take a lot, especially a lot of uncalled things that happen out there on the ice, which happens. You know, sometimes you got to take a number and get back to a guy. Sometimes you look for that immediate relief. But the way things happen here, I mean, if you take a stick foul or something like that, they call it. And they're much more likely to call it. And I think that was a tangle at the side of the net in which, for whatever reason, and maybe Brendan O'Reilly's just trying to fire his team up. He's going to get a double minor, I believe, for roughing here. Certainly, I mean, he's trying to get the Thunder going. He's trying to be a teammate in that sense. And you look at O'Reilly's stats, that's what he does. He's got a goal and 3 points, but 82 minutes in penalties. That's his role. But kudos to Frazio for not being goaded into that. 5:58, time of the double minor. River Dragons onto their first shot at the Georgia power play in this game. Yesterday they were 2 for 5. They moved up to fifth in the league at 17.6%. So 2 for roughing, 2 for unsportsmanlike, 6 of 1, half dozen of the other. River Dragons moving it along here, and there's a chance. Aldworth in front of Mayup couldn't get to the rebound. And a chance for Delaware to clear. And they are able to get it out to center here. Weber feeding it on the right side. Wilson's going to push, look for a shorthanded chance, but he had it knocked away. And now back come the River Dragons. Left side, Aldworth curls to the left half wall. He'll feed up to the left point with it now. Over to the right side, Frazio. Right half wall, Wickline, Frazio to the middle. High slot, shot through traffic, block. Ends up in the near corner. And Rasmus Asp able to clear it down. River Dragons change of the power play 7 minutes into the first. Scoreless so far between Columbus and Delaware. 2:52 and counting to go on the double minor. River Dragons, ooh, Greco did not connect with that pass. That's icing. Greco tried to get a stick on it. Not sure if it hopped on him or if it was just out of his reach. Either way, the faceoff comes back down to the right of Brennan Colgan. Puck is controlled by Delaware. There's a shot. Well, they hit their own guy with it there. Wolf now with a chance. Colgan will just bat it aside. And Columbus to the attack. Right side feed for King. King met a shoulder. Puck stays in, though. Storge a hand to the left side corner. Kelly. Greco down low. Tried to put it around the wall. That hit a leg, and now Delaware a chance to clear again. And a loft out to center. Milushkin tried to come down with a breakaway pass, but that one ends up with Colgan, who just plays it away to an open wing. Storage a hand, curling with it. Giving it to Kelly. Kelly, right side. Sends it into the corner. Storage a hand, cuts it off, comes back up the near side. Feeds it right between Greco and Kelly. They gave each other a bit of a look there, trying to figure out who was supposed to take that pass, and neither one of them did. Here's Underwood circling in his own end as the River Dragons change it up. Greco on the left side. Columbus trying to move it in, just really struggling right now to get out of their own way. Rogers on the right side. He'll dump it in. Chuck Costello also draws in for the River Dragons here, wearing number 25. He's out there now. Buck 23 to go on the power play. Doe into the slot. Petrantonio, wrist shot and a diving block. And Hanakainen struggling to get up to the near dot. Costello up top to Rogers. Rogers backs up. Swings it over. Into the left side, Petrantonio. Petrantonio up top to Rogers. Costello near dot, wrist shot. Tip behind the net. Austin Doe on it. Costello on the right half wall. Up top quickly to Rogers. Rogers, his shot. Save made in front. Rebound near wall. Costello on it. 48 seconds to go on the power play. Cross ice. There's a shot. That one is blocked again in front. Boy, Hanakainen. Rough shift, but he's doing his job. Now Colgan will come out, play it way ahead. Costello breaks in. He's got help going to the front of the net. Tried to toe drag around it. And Asp fell over the puck. It ends up at the right point. Costello there with room. Across ice. One-time shot. Right pad save. Nidchenko. Now Vanelli down low, crashing into the puck. Kicks it over towards Doe, but he lost it. To the line. Not out. Rogers holding. 17 seconds in the power play. Petrantonio up top to Rogers. Rogers with a seam and a wrist shot. Whipped it wide. Puck on the near wall. Tied up by Wickline. Rogers tried to walk through the slot with it. Had that knocked away by Wolf. Cleared to the line, not out. Now right back in. Wickline stepping in. Jemayev going to the net. Wickline into the right side corner. Takes a bump. Gets it towards Jemayev. He ties it up in the corner with Asp. Wickline, right point. Rogers. Deeks doesn't shoot. Sends it back down. Wickline lets it go. Aldworth, side of the net. Jemayev circling. Right half wall. Right point. Rogers, top of the dot. Can't let it go. Jemayev at the line. Pushed out to center. And now, oh, he's got players all over him. And somehow Jemayev came out with it. Feeds it back into Aldworth. Aldworth right side. Jemayev in front. Puck in the high slot. Frazio, a shot and a glove save. Nidchenko. That's going to bring us to a break. Still scoreless here in this first period, but the River Dragons trying to pour it on. 9:29 to go in the opening frame. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
When it comes to equipment, you don't have to pay more to get more. At SunSouth, we strive to provide the best customer service along with the best equipment. And right now, you can own quality John Deere equipment from SunSouth with 0% interest for 60 months. That's right, 0% interest for 60 months on top models, including John Deere 1 Series, 3 Series, and even 5 Series tractors. For the equipment to meet your needs, visit SunSouth. Equipment for those that do.
Restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires February 28, 2023.
All right, back here at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you in this SunSouth John Deere first period. Equipment for those that do. Scoreless, about halfway through. 9 minutes, 29 seconds left on that clock. Face-off will be coming up to the left of Jacob Nidchenko, getting the start this afternoon for the Thunder. Petrantonio Doe Underwood out there. And the face-off pushed ahead. Milushkin will move it out ahead to Lopsa. And he tried to walk in, but is squeezed off there on the back check. Frazio up the right side. Underwood into space in the wing for Petrantonio. Petrantonio putting it down behind the net. Doe after it. Doe trying to kick it free. Curls back to the near side. Doe on the wall. Frazio down for the point. Behind the net. Out the far side. Backhands it near corner. Underwood up top. Well, if Doe was a right-hand shot, that was a good pass, but Doe's a lefty, and the puck went right by him. Sent around by Colgan. Ozelinch out to center. Underwood at center all by himself. Just flips it in the backhand. He'll stop and go for the change. Delaware's got some time on this regroup. They get to center. Here comes Wilson dumping it in. Colgan elects to cover. Never a bad decision as a goaltender. Let your centers do their job. Try to win a face-off. 8:33 to go in the first. Draw coming up to the right here of the River Dragons cage. Draw one back by Storjahan. Does exactly that. Here goes Greco up the left side. He'll lead the charge in. Kelly going to the net. Greco to Kelly. Tipped on goal. That's stopped by Nidchenko. Puck is bounced out to center. Storjahan fell. Back the other way. O'Reilly tried to step in over the line. Knocked away from him. O'Reilly with a shot from the right side. Tumbling wide of the net. Kick to the left point. Where Asp will send it back to the half wall. There's a broken stick on the play. That belongs to Greco. Greco trying to body his man out in front as Kelly swats at it. Hanakainen keeping it in. Now we got a penalty coming up, and that's going to be against Delaware. And Greco wants to go with O'Reilly. Greco's got his mitt off. Is O'Reilly going to oblige him? The linesmen are trying to get in there and break it up. I understand the linesman. And again, a thankless job. I was talking about this earlier. Oh, my goodness. Sometimes you just take some shots inadvertently from guys. O'Reilly's getting a chat from a couple of different guys in teal, including LaBelle, who saying all of a sudden why you got your gloves glued on. There was initially a penalty coming against O'Reilly. Now Greco is in the box as well, so I don't know if they'll even these out or not. But again, if you're the River Dragons, you don't really have a reason to oblige the Thunder. Just as they did not oblige last night, and I know that the River Dragons on Military Night, you know, they're trying to start a little something early, try to stir the pot. You get an early fight in. Greco got a big hit in that knocked a pane of glass out yesterday. But Delaware did not oblige, and that was smart. Smart hockey by Delaware. Now, Delaware is trying to get the River Dragons to come down and, you know, scrap with them. And in a scoreless first period here, 7:49 to go, I understand from the Delaware side why they're trying to make that happen. Looks like they're both going to get on sportsmanlike conduct here. And then, well, maybe not. We'll figure this one out here. It looks like the River Dragons are going to be shorthanded. Now, I don't know how they come out of this shorthanded. On sportsmanlike conduct against Greco. I thought O'Reilly went into the box, but maybe he came back out when I was not looking. And I think... one of the referees is over at the River Dragons bench getting taped up. Again, that's a tough one. Actually, I think it's the linesman. Might have caught just something. Might have caught his hand. Injured him somehow. Looks like he's all right. All right, well, that's the only penalty, it looks like, that has been assessed here, at least for now. Let's blow this up a little. Okay, so Greco got two for roughing, two for unsportsmanlike. And two for roughing is what O'Reilly got. So Greco picked up an extra two for unsportsmanlike in there somewhere. That is why the River Dragons are on the First Franklin Financial penalty kill for the first time of the game. First Franklin Financial, personal loans at the speed of life. Yesterday, the Thunder went 0 for 8 with a man advantage. River Dragons have done a nice job against this Thunder power play unit. Although Delaware coming in ranked last in the league with a man advantage. As that puck goes out of play in the far side. 71.6% on the power play this year. That is last. 87.8% on the kill for the River Dragons. That leads the FPHL. So certainly one of the biggest strengths of the River Dragons game. Although they don't want to be shorthanded, they are good at it. 1:34 left to go in the extra minor against Greco. 7:20 now and counting as the puck is down. Scoreless here in the first. Now the puck, almost picked out of the air there by Jemayev. He couldn't quite come down with possession. Jemayev pesky on the forecheck along with Austin Doe out here in this shorthanded situation. Milushkin coming back in on the right side. He'll stop at the half wall. Try to set it up. Delaware around to the near side. Working his way up the wall. Delaney all the way to the line. Kept it in left side. Danilek with a backdoor feed and a diving block. What a nice play there. Jemayev smelled that one coming. Dove in front and might have even saved a really good scoring chance. Now the puck turned over at center to Storjahan and Kelly is in offside. Well, they put it onside. Okay, play continues. Danilek. Out the right side. And Milushkin electing to go all the way back into his own end. Leave it for Daniluk. Wilson pressured by Kelly. Delaware having trouble getting through neutral ice. This looks a little bit more like Friday's game in the beginning for Delaware. Now they're through. Houston hooked off it, though. Frazier behind the net, left side to Ozalinch. Ozalinch will send it down the ice. 5 seconds to go on the man advantage. Kelly steps up, maybe looking for a chance. Leaves it left side. Storjan had to chase to the wall, but we're back to 5-on-5. Costello, who was serving the minor, out of the box. And now Delaware move up on the left wing side, trying to cut in there. Grant Mentis had a cut off. Wolf with a chance. That one is steered wide. Centering feed, bounce to the far side. Kelly chasing after it. Kelly with a stretch, wanted to hit Costello at center, couldn't find him with it. Frazio tied up. Puck on the near corner. Storage a hand back to help out. Flips it around to the far side. Kelly put into the boards by Milushkin. Wolf in that pile as well. Storage a hand joining it. Now we get a whistle. And that's going to draw a penalty. It's going to be Jacob Kelly heading to the penalty box. And the River Dragons shorthanded once again. Roughing the indication. 14:54, time of the penalty. Well, this game may bog down into a parade to the penalty box here. Face-off coming up to the left. Well, we end up with 4-on-4 here. So, not just Kelly. Although Kelly's got an extra 2 on his side. The referee says, hang on a minute. Wolf is in there with him. So now Delaney heads back off. Somebody make up my mind for me. What are we doing here? Are we doing 4-on-4? Maybe we are. Okay, so no penalty kill. River Dragons will win the draw and get it through center. Here's Milushkin trying to walk back into the backhand save made. And the River Dragons the other way. Petrantonio moving in, flips it, looking for Vanelli on the back door, put it behind him, and now Vanelli. Well, Vanelli's going to go to the box for tripping here, and that's one of those unfortunate moments. The Thunder player stepped on the blade of his stick while they were both turning, and he went into the wall pretty heavy. I didn't see who that was. That's just bad luck when it comes to Vanelli. And well, that's Hanakainen. Oh, he's had a rough game. He got hurt twice blocking shots, and now he goes into the boards heavily. We're going to take a break when we come back. Thunder, the power play. 4:43 to go in the first. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
With 0% interest for 60 months. That's right, 0% interest for 60 months on top models, including John Deere 1 Series, 3 Series, and even 5 Series tractors. For the equipment to meet your needs, visit SunSouth. Equipment for those that do.
Restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires February 28, 2023.
For Beam, community isn't just a place. It's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
So, as we come back here to the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you. We have had fun trying to sort this one out. It's 4-on-3 now. And we still have some figuring to do here over at the scorer's table. And now we got a fresh puck out there. It's been a while since we've had this much ice out there, but 4-on-3, River Dragons shorthanded once again. And they are now back on the First Franklin Financial penalty kill. Personal loans at the speed of life. So Columbus, 126 of 4-on-3 to kill off, and then the remaining will be 5-on-4 when both Kelly and Wolf come out of the box together. Weber feeding it down low side of that. Wilson trying to go back door. That pass in front hit Frazier in the skates. Doesn't get across. Wilson on to the right side. Daniluk leaving it off of the right circle. Milushkin, right point. Into the right side corner. Feed in front. Weber. That one hit Frazier in the skates. And so Delaware going to try to move it around again. Here's Wilson with the backhand. Cross ice feed and a save made by Colgan coming to his right. Ozalich sliding it around the wall, cut off of the line by Petrantonio, and he will now send it down the rest of the way. Nitschenko to leave it behind the net as the Thunder moving it up with about a half minute to go in a 4-on-3 situation. Then it will go to 5-on-4 for 23 seconds. Puck right in on Colgan. No problem there. Brendan Colgan holding on. Faceoff will come to his left with 3:29 left to go in the Sun-South John Deere first period. LaBelle talking it over with Wickline here, who's going to prepare to take this faceoff to the left of Colgan. Looks like Rogers is the other defenseman right now. And the puck goes right in on goal. Colgan has to make a save in front. On a tricky bouncer, Delaney had a good attempt there. Rebound is cleared out. Delaware back to it again. Left side, Grant Mentis cuts in, lost it. Rogers sends it down. Now we're 5-on-4. Kelly and Wolf out of the box. 19 seconds to go in the first Franklin Financial penalty kill for the River Dragons. Grant Mentis, left side, weaves in. High slot, fed it across. Venstrom couldn't come down with it. And Columbus able to clear it out. That should do it. Another successful Abercrombie bonding penalty kill for the River Dragons. Vanelli out of the box. 2:35 to go in the first period. Scoreless between the River Dragons and the Thunder. Final time this season here in Columbus. Aldworth able to knock that puck free. And it's tipped away to center. Storjahan. Up in the wing, moving in with a backhand across block. The second attempt, Aldworth, and he couldn't get it to go. Swings it around to the left point. What do we have here? Oh, the net came off. Net comes off in the Delaware end. Looks like they're saying it's intentional because they're not allowing Delaware to change. Interesting. The River Dragons, however, will put out Storjahan, Kelly King, along with Frazio and Ozalich. Storjahan in for the faceoff, and that is cut back by Delaware around the rim to the near side. Milushkin tried to play it out to center. He did get it there. Frazio back to King. King leaving it into space. Storjahan kicks it to himself, cuts through the D. Shot, left pad, save Nitschenko. Kelly couldn't fight that one free from Milushkin. Puck ends up on the right side, sent down the ice, chased by Frazier. There'll be no icing here. Frazier loops behind the River Dragons net onto the right wing for King. King cross his feet, picked off. Wilson walking back in, has some room, ran out of room as Ozalich closed him off quickly, and he never got a shot away. Now back of the River Dragons. Left side of your Storjahan with speed, trying to get around the D. Storjahan had it knocked off his stick. Kelly following up the play, though, chips it into the left side corner. Storjahan stays up to force Wolf to reverse it behind the net. 1:20 to go in the first. No score between Columbus and Delaware. Greco will feed that one across to LaBelle. LaBelle back over to Greco on the right side. Greco skating it in on the wing. Wrister, tip behind the net. Asp, far side, up the wall. Cut off by Underwood on the left wing. Puck still not out of the zone. Underwood battling to keep it in. Now finally it's pulled out of the pile here by Wolf. He has Costello on him. Costello knocks it free back to the defense. Here's Greco on the right wing. Greco ahead. Costello tried to take it out of his skates. Couldn't. Played ahead. LaBelle blocked the pass. Underwood tried to glove it to himself. Lost the handle on it, though. Bouncing around at center. Finds Underwood again anyway. Here's Costello at the line. Brings it in right side. Costello stops looking for room. Backhand into the slot. Doe feeding left side. LaBelle crashing. Rolling puck. Underwood couldn't get a shot away. And now 19 seconds to go in the period. Delaware up the right side. They'll walk in. Here's a chance. Shot. Colgan save. Rebound off the outside of the net. Lopsa had an open cage and he couldn't put it home. Danilock back at center. He'll fire one in off the shin pad of Underwood. 4 seconds to go. Costello with a long shot. That forces a save as we come to the horn. River Dragons and the Thunder do not end up with any pucks going in the net, but there were certainly some very good scoring chances in that opening frame. But as we head off into the sunset of the Sun South John Deere first period, scoreless indeed. We'll sort everything out for you from that first period. We've got to look inside the numbers coming your way. A check of the Zelmo zipping out of town scoreboard. And in this first period intermission, we'll be joined by Thomas Aldworth. And that'll be coming up next. It's time for the Chick-fil-A first intermission report. Stay tuned. We've got plenty more coming your way. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Markey, we're America's on-time electrician. We all count on our home's electrical outlets to provide us the power we need when we need it. But sometimes an overloaded circuit can lead to a blown outlet. So leave it to the pros at Mr. Sparky. We'll get it done right and get it done safely. Call now for $50 off electrical repairs.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Limitations and restrictions may apply. Independently owned and operated. Licensed in the respective state or county.
Oral and maxillofacial surgeons Mark Zwicky, Lee Allen practice a traditional scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery with over 60 years of combined expertise, ranging from oral pathology to wisdom tooth removal. They perform a full range of dental implant and bone grafting procedures, as well as non-invasive surgical facial cosmetic procedures. That level of expertise is why the River Dragons trust them. Call them in Columbus at 596-1757 or in LaGrange at 884-2655.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
When the River Dragons have a breakdown, the puck can end up in the back of the net. But when your car has a breakdown, you need a reliable tow partner. Trust the tow company the River Dragons depend on, Tuffy's Towing. Tuffy's tows many types of vehicles in the Chattahoochee Valley. Call 706-457-0985 for a quote or go online to tuffystowing.com. Tuffy's, we tow more.
Welcome back on the Chick-fil-A First Intermission Report. We're joined by Thomas Aldworth. First of all, Thomas, thanks for joining us, and we really appreciate you taking the time here. Big night for you last night. Talk a little bit about, first of all, military night, absolutely packed building, and just it seemed like everything was going in.
Yeah, I mean, it was wild. The fans were crazy. You know, when you're on the ice and you're looking at the stands, you see hundreds and hundreds of screaming fans up there wearing all in their uniforms and stuff like that. It was really crazy, so it was nice to see that. Got me fired up, and I just managed to get a couple breakaways, and my shot wasn't falling on Friday. had a lot of chances on Friday. They weren't going in. So on Saturday, I just really wanted to bear down and just, you know, shoot the puck hard, and they eventually went in. So it was going in for me. It was going well.
I got to say, where Pavlos hits you with that breakaway pass, I mean, that was an outstanding play all the way around.
Yeah, I didn't even expect that, honestly. I was actually going to change at first, and I saw the puck coming, and I was like, might as well stay on the ice and try to go for it. That was a crazy pass, and I've never seen a goalie pass like that before, so that was really awesome.
It's like having a third defenseman back there almost.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And he's super confident with the puck, so it's really nice.
Talk a little bit about the success you guys have had as a line this year. And I know somewhat interchangeable on the wings at times, mm-hmm. but it really seems like the chemistry is there right now.
Yeah, I've known Wick since I was 10 years old, so me and him have had that chem for a while now, and playing with Group this year has been awesome, too. You know, he works really hard, and he's awesome on the walls, and he's got a great shot, too. So it's always nice. And in practice, we have our chemistry going, stuff like that. So we bond well off the ice, too. So you know, it really works when we're on the ice.
I know you guys recently had gone through a little bit of a tough stretch, especially mm-hmm. against Carolina. And then you dropped the game Friday night. But to have an emphatic response like that, what does that say about this team?
This team, you know, we don't quit. A lot of heart in our room. We got a lot of skill, a lot of talent up front. On the back end, we got a lot of guys who work hard and make the right plays. So we're definitely a dangerous team.
Thomas, thanks for joining us. Best of luck.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
All right, back with more of the Chick-fil-A First Intermission Report in just a moment. Welcome back on the Chick-fil-A First Intermission Report. We're joined by Thomas Aldworth. First of all, Thomas, thanks for joining us, and we really appreciate you taking the time here. Big night for you last night. Talk a little bit about, first of all, military night, absolutely packed building, and just it seemed like everything was going in.
Yeah, I mean, it was wild. The fans were crazy. You know, when you're on the ice and you're looking at the stands, you see hundreds and hundreds of screaming fans up there wearing all in their uniforms.
Serviced on the web at ctstires.com.
HydroLife Therapy in Old Town is your one-stop recovery shop to get you back to 100%. With IV therapy treatments, cryotherapy, and compression therapy all under one roof, HydroLife treatments are packed with nutrients to increase energy and boost your immune system. Join the IV League today for the most affordable way to feel better, look better, and start accomplishing more. Online at HydroLifeTherapy.com/Columbus. HydroLife Therapy. Start living your best life.
While the River Dragons handle pests on the ice, Orkin takes care of rodents and pests at your home or business. Locally owned and operated, Orkin creates a custom pest plan specifically for you. Orkin can help eliminate and control mice, bed bugs, ants, roaches, stinging insects, and cockroaches, just to name a few. Remember, they're not happy until you're happy. So visit Orkin.com for a free estimate, and trust the only pest control service the Dragons trust, Orkin. Now, if they could just control seawolves and thunderbirds.
Heroes of Valhalla is your go-to place for all of your gunsmithing and firearms needs. They also specialize in Cerakote finishing as well as hydro dipping, which offers over 1,000 different pattern options. Check them out online at heroesofvalhalla.us or stop by the shop at 6320 Bradley Park Drive in Columbus. They're open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Online at heroesofvalhalla.us.
In 1999, Whatley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We're proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
We are in our first period intermission report, brought to you by Chick-fil-A. We've got our Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard coming up in just a little bit. But first, let's take a look inside the numbers from period number one. No goals to tell you about, but plenty of penalties, as the teams each ended up racking up 18 minutes apiece. Two power plays apiece, and both teams 0 for 2 with the man advantage so far. We had a fight early on involving LaBelle and Gafarov. Gafarov hit his head on the ice at the end of that when both players were kind of spun down to the ice. Gafarov went in forehead first and have not seen him back. Wondering if he's okay. They did take him off for observation, and perhaps it's been a rough weekend for the Thunder. They've really they've had a tough one. I mean, Toivo Hanakainen blocked two shots in that period. Both of them staggered him. Then later on, He tripped on Adam Vanelli's stick blade and went hard into the boards and had to be helped off the ice. It's a rough day, rough Sunday for Hanakainen. But Delaware had Rasmus Asp injured in yesterday's game. Now, he is back for today's game, so he did make it back out there. But, boy, a lot of bumps and bruises mounting for the Delaware Thunder here as they try to get through this one. Shots on goal in that period favored the hometown River Dragons 12-9. And I feel like the way this game is going to go penalty-wise is going to be largely dictated by the scoreboard. Delaware is a little frustrated after last night. You get blown out 9-0. Well, as I said, the response is important. That is one of the things we're looking at, is to see what is the response going to be from this River Dragons team. How do they come out? The Thunder, how do they come out? I thought the Thunder pushed back pretty well. It took them a little while to get it going. To get the legs going, but much like the first period on Friday, they got the legs going eventually and looked much better for it. Now, can the River Dragons do what they did yesterday? They only got that one goal in the first period, and that one, again, was even maybe did it go in, did it not go in? Referee did say it went in, so hey, yes, of course it counts, but it was only one. But then, coming out in the second and the third period, the River Dragons got down to business, and then they scored 8 more. And so for Columbus, that's what they really need to do. They need to just, you know, put the hammer down, get it going, and really take control of this hockey game, get their 3 points, and call it a good weekend. We have the Chick-fil-A cow, by the way, riding on the Zamboni and dressed as a princess. I don't think I've ever seen that. So that's a pretty nifty getup. But we are in the Chick-fil-A first period intermission, and that's a look inside the numbers from that first period of hockey. Let's take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard, which is brought to you by Zelmo's Zippin. Zelmo's has been fueling life's passions since 1999. And right now at First Arena in Elmira, the only other game going on in the FPHL today. Watertown and Elmira are tied up at 1, and that game is late in the third period. We might be looking at a little bit of OT there. We'll see how that one will work itself out. A little bit busier on a Sunday in the NHL. One game going on right now. Oilers and Avalanche. This is an offensive barn burner. 5-4 Oilers. Halfway through period number 3. McKinnon's got a pair in that one. His 19th and 20th of the season. Leon Draisaitl is 33rd. Coming up later, you got Leafs at Blackhawks, Jets at Devils, Blue Jackets at Coyotes. Games from earlier today in the books. Wild beat the Preds 4-3, and the Senators topped the Blues 7-2 in that one. Tim Stützle, his 26th of the year. Brady Tkachuk, his 24th, and Alex DeBrincat, his 19th. Stützle had a pair in that game, by the way. As the Blues have gone into full rebuild mode after trading away Ryan O'Reilly, after getting rid of Vladimir Tarasenko, who had been rumored to be on the move at some point for a couple of years now. In that Wild game, by the way, Kirill the Thrill, Kaprizov with a pair of goals, his 32nd, 33rd of the year as well. All right, Daytona 500, if you are DVRing the race at home or what have you, I'm going to give you a moment here. We've had a lead change again, and I'm going to give it to you. They're just coming off a yellow flag here. So if you don't want to know what's going on, you've got a couple seconds here. I'm going to count it down till I tell you what's going on. All right, 3, 2, 1. Bubba Wallace started 15th in this race. He is now your race leader. And Eric Almirola is second. And not quite a second gap there is the field being shuffled around. I told you by that yellow. And right now, they are trying to get back to racing with what's going on. This is lap number 134 of 200. All right, you can listen again. I'm not going to go on for 5 minutes about what's going on in the race, because that kind of defeats the purpose if you don't want to know. And if you do want to know, I just gave you what you needed to know. And that one, of course, you could follow online as well. And we thank you for being a part of River Dragons hockey here today. And if you are here local in the community, we would like to remind you that there is a diaper drive going on to support the Junior League of Columbus, you can bring a donation of diapers or baby wipes or both and meet River Dragons players at WTVM on Wednesday, February 22nd from noon to 6:30. You can drop your donation off right at the station and grab a selfie with your favorite players. Also, want to say thank you to those who have donated throughout the weekend here at the games as well. Now, if you're planning on making a purchase, I will tell you this. The older, larger sizes of diapers are in greater demand. I think a lot of people, kind of like when you go to a baby shower, everybody buys newborn diapers. Your best gift is to buy 6 to 12 months, 12 to 24 months. Well, it's kind of the same with the diaper drive. You know, you got to think out a little bit. I think a lot of people just grab those newborn ones. And believe me, every donation makes a huge difference right here in the Chattahoochee Valley. But the older sizes are in greater demand right now, so just putting that out there for you. If you are going to come by, and again, we're going to be at WTVM on Wednesday, February 22nd from noon to 6:30. Meet the River Dragons players, drop off your donation, and help out right here in the Chattahoochee Valley. Don't forget to tune in to the River Dragons Radio Coaches Show, presented by Mike Costello Law every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. on 106.9 Really Rocks, Columbus's Real Rock Station, and our radio affiliates. Coach Bichard joined every week by a different River Dragons player every week, and the River Dragons TV Coaches Show airs every Thursday night at 7 p.m. on CTN Channel 16. We're playing at 11 a.m. on Saturday mornings. Don't miss it. And WYBU Channel 16 is another tremendous sponsor of River Dragons hockey. We appreciate them and our partnership with WTVM and, of course, Bounce 7. Welcome to all of our viewers over on Bounce 7. And I mentioned our flagship ship station and our radio affiliates, WZEV 90.5 FM, Classic Hits of Lineville, WBRQ 91.9 FM, Blues Time in the City of LaGrange, and WQEE 99.1 FM, home of Southern Sports and Talk in Noonan. We appreciate all of you being a part of River Dragons hockey. We'll take a break. When we come back, that's it for the Chick-fil-A First Intermission Report. Scoreless through 1 second period action is coming your way next. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Hey, Columbus River Dragons fans. I'm meteorologist Elise Ushman in the WTVM Storm Team 9 Alert Center with a look at your forecast. After the game tonight, we're going to be seeing temperatures into the mid-50s. Overnight, and as you head out the door tomorrow, into the mid-40s. Monday is going to be another partly cloudy day. Temperatures even warmer into the mid-70s. A really pleasant start to our work week, and this warming trend is going to continue as we go through the rest of the week. Overnight Monday, temperatures will stay in the upper 50s. For Tuesday afternoon, we'll be closer to the 80-degree mark, and we'll start to see a chance at a shower or two. That slim chance at a shower will stick around through the end of the work week, and by the weekend, we should see a little bit more sunshine. Temperatures every single day will stay in the low 80s. Wednesday through Sunday, we'll see a change in this pattern as we get into the very next work week, temperatures back into the 70s. We'll be right back on the Columbus River Dragons Broadcast Network.
Hey guys, this is Mike Costello of the Mike Costello Law Firm.
It's Rick Willis of the Mike Costello Law Firm.
Did you know that car accidents are the number one case of injuries in the U.S.? So if you find yourself in a car wreck,
call or text me at 844-GET-MIKE or visit us at MikeCostelloLawFirm.com.
So do yourself a favor and I hope that you learned. Been in the wreck, call the Mike Costello Law Firm.
So if you've been injured, please give us a call.
Let's have a conversation.
Michael G. Hostelo, 1301 First Avenue, Suite 101, Columbus, 31901.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner, cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside, technology with a human touch.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer. and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call 706-324-6661.
Back here at the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan back here with you as we get ready to go for second period action. Your second period is brought to you by Kinetic Credit Union. Thanks to Thomas Aldworth for joining us there in the first period intermission. Aldworth, how about it? 4 goals, 5 points yesterday. What an outing for him. First River Dragon to pot 4 in a game this season. He's up to 16 now on the year. And right now we have a referee operating a squeegee, trying to get rid of some of the excess water behind the net. Now we're getting ready to drop the puck. Let's get this second period underway. Tom Callahan here with you from the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Harvey Lumber, serving the community for over 150 years. And the River Dragons going right to left here in front of the Harvey Lumber Press Box to start period number 2. Puck in the defensive zone for Columbus. They turn it over in the slot, but a little bit of a comedy of errors there for Delaware. Players running into one another, and it ends up back out at center. Grant Mentis takes a check on the near side, got the puck away to the left wing, dumps it in on Colgan, who's just going to catch and hang on for the faceoff. 29 seconds gone in the second period. Thunder and the River Dragons scoreless. Faceoff to the right of Colgan. And it's one back. Columbus controlling around the rim. It goes to the right point. Kept in. A shot by Ivanov is blocked down in front. And now right back. Up the left side is King. King and over the line. Into the high slot. There's a shot. Storjan missed the net. Rebound Kelly. That shot down to the left post. To the right point. Frazio. Long shot. And Idchenko with a glove save. He'll hold on to it. Face off over to the left of the Thunder net as Petrantonio steps out with Doe and Underwood. Greca with LaBelle on the points. There's a shot coming in from the right point, sent wide. LaBelle pinching from the left side, trying to keep it in. Underwood backing him up, can't keep it in either. And away to center, here's Wilson. Wilson moving in, trying to put it across. Greca blocked the pass. Puck in the far side corner, Venstrom after it. Off the back of the net. Ilyushkin, puck free side of the goal. Colgan the save, and he's able to hang on to that rebound there. Colgan was not fooled, did not move off that right post. Stayed glued to it. Makes that a much easier save. Face off to the right of Colgan. Pushed across, here's Underwood. Underwood moving ahead at center. He'll fling it in. That one, ooh. That hit one of the defense. Oh, please don't tell me that's Hanakainen. Oh, it was. Hanakainen got hit up high with that puck. He is having a hard day's night out there. Oh, my goodness. Back comes Delaware up the right side. O'Reilly weaving in with a long shot wide of the net, and he got dropped by Greco. Oh, boy, he's headed off the ice and in some discomfort here. Greco is getting talked to by a lot of white jerseys after that hit, and he caught O'Reilly coming hard across the slot. It actually looked like it broke a piece of equipment off of something that belonged to O'Reilly. And now they're waving the medical staff over to look at O'Reilly. Oh, this has been a rough game for the Delaware Thunder. O'Reilly seems to be okay. They're taking a look at him on the bench. They're going to have approximately 37 ice bags for Toivo Hanakainen, who's been hurt twice blocking a shot, once getting knocked into the boards, and then he took a puck in the face to start the second period. He's had a heck of a start. O'Reilly just got rocked on that Greco hit, and O'Reilly's been involved. Surprisingly, nothing he's been involved in has been called a fight. But Gafarov, who wasn't a fight, went down headfirst into the ice earlier on in the game. And I don't think he's back on that. I've been trying to find if there is a 22 on the bench for Delaware, but I don't think I've seen him over there. Now the referee, of course, is getting it from Delaware's head coach, Lou Santini. Face off to the right of Colgan. We do stay 5-on-5. There was no penalty on the hit. It's Jemayev, left side, pushing it ahead. Wick line, it comes back to Jemayev. And now turned away at center, but moving up is Vanelli. Vanelli trying to stick handle his way in through the traffic. A backhander that went wide. Nice job by Vanelli to even get a shot off with all that. Wick line on the right side. He'll feed it back down, looking for Aldworth. Aldworth in the corner. Jemayev over to help out. Lost it. Up the middle it goes. Now Delaware away to center. Wolf on the left wing, carrying it wide of Rogers. His off-angle shot. Colgan cuts that off of the right post. And Wickline. Cross ice. Couldn't force it through. He had Jemayev streaking, but it was going to be a tough chance to get it over there. 2.5 into the second period. Well, Sunday matinee hockey action here. Grant Mentis falls, but is able to work himself out of trouble. Aldworth trying to cut back in with it, and he does. Aldworth in, looking for Jemayev in front. Shot saved, Nitchenko. He doesn't have the rebound, but he got the whistle. Ooh, man, he reached out with a glove. Didn't quite get the mitt over it, but it was enough to sell the referee. So the faceoff will stay to his right. And the River Dragons get a good chance here. Stuart Jahan, Kelly King out with Ozolinch and Frazio. Stuart Jahan wins it back. Here's Kelly. Puts it in on goal. Shot tipped by King. Nitchenko makes the save. Stuart Jahan on the rebound. Into the slot. Kelly a little too hot there on the pass, but Ozolinch keeps it in. Far side. King looking in front. His pass deflected to the near glass. Wilson out to center. And now there's a chance in. That one is shouldered down on a high wrist shot by Milushkin there. Milushkin after it behind the net. Forced out there is Frazio. Ahead to Storjahan. 3-on-2 developing if they hurry. King on the right side. Into the slot and a little too far for Storjahan. Turned right back the other way by Wilson. Wilson will fling it in. Delaware's going to head to a change. Milushkin stays up on the forecheck, though, while Colgan plays it around to Kelly on the left wing. His stretch to center, that finds Storjahan. King trailing the play, cutting in. Back door, looking for Kelly. Puck was behind him, and he couldn't hang on to possession. Wilson back to center, dumps it in. Now Delaware will finish its change because Colgan is going to elect to just catch and hold. Not quite 4 minutes into the second period here. River Dragons and Thunder. A little bit of a diminished pace, diminished energy here today, especially you have to imagine physically, emotionally drained are the River Dragons after yesterday. Again, the sold-out crowd, a 9-0 win here. And for both teams, it's their third game in 3 days. Delaware's got to head home after this. Here's LaBelle. Sent ahead Doe, hooked away from him. Greco, big hit on the far side there as he finishes his check. Puck down, and that's icing. Greco followed through there on Lopsa right in front of the River Dragons bench. And Lopsa's going to head off the ice. They're dropping like flies for the Delaware Thunder right now. Delaware has only 2, 4, 6, 8 guys left on the bench. They have 13 skaters left in this hockey game right now. Faceoff will be coming up to the left of the goaltender, Jacob Nichenko. He stopped all 16 River Dragon shots he's faced so far. Petrantonio in, and now Malushkin jumped early, so they're going to throw Delaware Center out of the draw. That allows Petrantonio to win it back. Shot from the point off the tip of the mitt. Rebound into the corner. Petrantonio behind the net looking for Costello. Costello out the near side. He'll send it deep for Doe. Doe back on the wall here. Costello. Costello, left point. LaBelle, long shot. Blocker save. Rebound in the near corner. Ivanov gave it up right in front of the net. Doe had a pinball off his skates. Couldn't quite hang on to it there. And now it's pushed away to center. Greco steps up, moves it ahead, and in as Wickline. Cutting in for the right side of the shot. Save made, and Nichenko holds on. As Wickline barreling to the net, Doe was looking for that rebound, but there was none to be found. 4:53 into the second period. Still looking for the first goal of the game. Wickline talking to the ref. So it's Wickline, Aldworth, Jemayev out there. Vanelli and Rogers on D. Wickline winning the puck back to the point right side. Long shot coming in, and that one is deflected away, and the rebound ends up out of play, so we will end up with another faceoff to the left of the Delaware net. Another chance to win a draw here for Wickline. In against Weber. Hannakainen ends up with it. He'll put it around to Wolf, and now Weber attacking through center. Weber right up the middle. Pass the D to the backhand. Couldn't get a shot off. Nice recovery there by Vanelli to turn and be able to pivot, chase him down. Left side, Grant Mentis trying to battle a bouncer into the slot. Wolf with a turnaround chance. That hit a body. Vanelli on it. Up the right side to Wickline. Wickline carries it ahead. They're working over the line. Leaving it off on the right side. Backdoor feed. Just missed Jemayev. Sent right back down low by Vanelli. Jemayev tried to kick it to himself up the wall. Wickline able to knock it back towards Jemayev. Puck around to the right side. Wickline gets to the boards. Feeds the right point. Rogers is able to keep it in. Rogers, quick shot. And he whipped that one wide and high on the stick side. Now race the other way. Grant Mentis hustling. He'll have an off angle if he can bring it in. It's all the way down to the goal line, so no icing here, but unable to do anything with it. Grant Mentis was rubbed out by Vanelli, but Vanelli put it into the skates of Milushkin. Got it back on the far side. River Dragons are at the end of a long shift here. Milushkin wheeling in the offensive zone. Puts it into the right side. Here's Wilson. Wilson to the right point. Asp. His shot in. Colgan the save, and he hangs on. Squeezing that one in the gear. 6:14 gone to the second. Scoreless in this one. River Dragons and the Delaware Thunder here on a Sunday afternoon at the Columbus Civic Center. This is River Dragons Hockey.
I'm away at college. Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
What's up, Columbus, Phoenix City, and all the bi-state area? This is Mike Hostolo of the Mike Hostolo Law Firm.
Once we take on a borrowing case, it's not just about law. It is our duty to provide and to give that client the best possible experience.
If you think you need us, call or text us. We got you.
Michael G. Hostolo, 1301 First Avenue, Suite 101, Columbus, 31901, 762-221-5616.
Time for your mind, so it locks and loads.
Back in the Columbus Civic Center, second period. We haven't even gotten to the intermission yet. Tom's trying to fast forward the game again. That happens. We've only played 6:14 of the second period, so I am way ahead of myself.
All
The River Dragons and Air Force Heating and Air want to express our gratitude to our servicemen and women currently defending our freedom and, of course, our veterans. Thank you for your service. Face off to the left of Colgan. Spun around the wall to the far side. King has to take two swats at it to get it out. Ends up coming back to him at center. Here's Kelly. He'll backhand it in. Storjahan will move up on the forecheck here. Danluck tried to spin out from behind his own net. Pushed back in behind. King steals. Kelly, quick shot, and a save made there. Nichenko takes it the chest protector. Hangs on. King, Kelly, Storjahan up front. Mozalinch and Frazier on the points. Face-off is one back, and Delaware will feed it around to the far side. Malushkin couldn't clear it out. Frazier holding it in with a long shot. Tipped off the outside of the net by Kelly. King, right side. Storjahan wheels over to the near wing. On the backhand, Storjahan feeds it back into the corner. Kelly pulls it out of the pile, looking up top through the slot. Off the heel of Frazier, stick it. It goes out of the zone. Back the other way, here's Wilson. Into the left side corner, watched by Frazier. Storjahan back to pick that pass off. King ahead left side to Kelly. Kelly tried to walk around the D. Asp couldn't clear it out, though. Long shot in, forces a left pad. Save now clear to the line, but not out. River Dragons holding it in. Underwood to the right wing side. Columbus actually changing the lines here and still keeping possession. Left pointers, LaBelle, his shot in, tipped in front. That one might have hit Asp. There's Petrantonio on the right corner. Petrantonio wraps it around behind the net. Looking into the slot, tried to feed the point, and he turned it over. Milushkin can get to center with it. He'll get knocked down as he dumps it in. Greco wheels the net. Left side, LaBelle. Underwood moving in. He's got Petrantonio with him. High slot to Doe. Doe, traffic wrister, and that one just getting a piece. Nichenko coming up on 8 minutes gone in the second. No score. River Dragons still with possession. There's a chance on the slot. Shot. Petrantonio glove save. Rebound. Still sitting free. And they score. Josh Petrantonio able to finally pull it out of the pile in front of the Delaware net. He puts it past the sprawling goaltender. And the River Dragons strike first. It's 1-0. That goal was plenty of River Dragons persistence. They kept battling away, trying to make something happen, and finally in front, we're able to pick up the loose puck and put it home. And now we have another injured Delaware Thunder player. That is Rasmus Asp. Yes, he is not putting any weight on his right leg. No, he's going to come right off the ice. Oh, what a shame. This is such a hard, hard day for the Delaware Thunder. They are losing players left and right. Petrantonio's 11th of the year. .909 time of the goal. Comes on the 22nd shot of the evening for the River Dragons. Here's Dana Barker. River Dragons push back in. Jemayev scores! Alexander Jemayev cashes in on a goal-mouth pass from Thomas Aldworth. And the River Dragons back-to-back goals. Suddenly it's 2-0. Welcome back to the lineup, Alexander Jemayev. He's got his 10th. Those goals, 11 seconds apart. Well, that changed the complexion of the game in a hurry. Here's Vanelli after it, into the near corner. Right up the slot. And now it's Captain Milushkin behind the net. Grant Mentis on it. Allworth. Playing it away up the right side to Wickline, who will just bash that out on the backhand. Delaware needs to have the response now. Wickline backhanding it ahead. Here's Allworth on the right side. He'll wheel in high slot. Jamea backing up in front. A shot tipped behind the goal. Allworth with Wickline right there in his kitchen gives it to him. Wickline into the corner. Tied up over there on the far side. Allworth steals it back. Allworth ran into Jamea from the slot, though. That allows Delaware to move it out. So Doe and Underwood, the assists on the Petrantonio goal. And then Allworth and Wickline, the assist on Jemayev's goal. And again, 11 seconds apart. River Dragons up 2-0 now. That ends up as an icing call. .941 gone here in the second period, and the shots all of a sudden have tilted in favor of the River Dragons, 23-13 for the hockey game. Faceoff is won back into the right wing corner. Delaware controlling, but unable to clear. Kelly stole it back. Storjahan tying up his man Kelly on the left half wall with it. Kelly into the corner looking for Storjahan. Storjahan on the far side. King. Right point, Frazio. Left side, here's Ozilinch walking in with a shot. Left pad save, rebound across. Fed up top, here's Frazio. Long wrister in, and a glove save there. Caught and held by Nidchenko. That's going to carry us to a break with 9:54 to go in the second period. River Dragons get goals from Petrantonio and Jemayev. They lead it 2-0. Back with more in a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like chuck-a-pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app, energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Back at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you. Thank you so much for joining me for Columbus River Dragons Hockey. So pleased to have you here, not now, but all season long. Really appreciate the support from the fans, from the parents, I'm sure, the players who listen in on both sides. Of course, my folks are always there. My sister is there. We appreciate all of you being a part of River Dragons Hockey as well. All of our fine sponsors right here in the Chattahoochee Valley community and everybody who's a part of this great game. Right now, the River Dragons with a 2-0 lead over the Delaware Thunder. And now here's Storjahan has room, walks in left side, drive, and a save made. Nidchenko way out on the angle to greet him. Kelly trying to cycle into the slot, pulls it up to the blue line, stops there, works to his right. Leaves it back off Ozilinch, left point, looking, wrister, tipped out of play. I think King got his stick to it, just deflected it high. Faceoff will stay inside, 9:26 to go in the second. The Thunder bench grows shorter and shorter. They are without now Asp, who is out of the game, as he went off, not putting any weight on his right leg. We'll keep an eye to see if he comes back. Denis Skaforov, hurt in a fight in the first period, has not come back into the hockey game as Delaware clears the zone here. And now Petrantonio at center. Lopsa left the ice surface. I don't know if he's come back. O'Reilly took a heavy hit, and there is no icing here as it's cleared down for Delaware. Haven't seen him take a shift since, but I don't think he's left the ice. Wilson in the high slot with a shot right into the chest protector of Brendan Colgan. But yeah, including, so they've got now 7 players left on the Delaware bench. 8 if you count the backup goaltender tonight, Trevor Martin. That's tough. Looks like they're down to basically 4D and 5 forwards outside of what's on the... So 4D and I guess 8 forwards is what Delaware is operating with right now. Here's Costello cutting into his right with a rolling puck. Ends up in the near side corner. Certainly you don't ever want to see anybody get hurt. I hope that all those guys are okay. It's just been a rough day. And again, Hanakainen has been just absolutely pelted out there. He's staying in the game. He's still out there, but a couple of blocked shots. Got hit in the face with a clearing attempt. Went awkwardly into the boards at one point. The list gets longer. Milushkin trying to bring it in for Delaware in the right wing. Looked to throw it in front. Couldn't quite get it through. Now Wilson with it on the left side boards. Off angle chance. Shoulder save Colgan. But Colgan is so tall, even when he's down on a knee, as long as he's against that post, he pretty much covers most of the daylight. Here's LaBelle trying to get back the other way with it. And that'll be cleared down. And no icing here. Will not have enough gas. 7:49 to go in the second. 2-0 River Dragons in the lead. Goals 11 seconds apart. Petrantonio and Jemayev. LaBelle up the left side. Jemayev, right wing feed. Here's Underwood cutting, and he had 2 last night. Underwood curling behind the net, rubbed off on the wall. And a bouncing puck in the corner. Ends up fed to the left point. Vanelli onto the right side. Rogers doesn't shoot, spins back. He'll feed it down to the corner. Jemayev couldn't hang on to it. Underwood grabs it behind the net. Underwood, Vanelli down low to the left corner. Vanelli, pass in front. Wanted Wickline, popped up in the air. And now one of the Thunder players ends up on top of the puck for a moment, and now it's wedged out of the zone. Rogers with a bank pass back. Jemayev lost it. Rogers will hustle onto the left wing side against Weber. Weber trying to shake him and cut in front. Puck get on goal. That went off the skate of Jemayev. Turned out to be a dangerous chance just on a chance deflection. 6:52 to go in this second period. And the second period is presented by Kinetic Credit Union. I want to say congratulations to the latest winners in the Air Force Heating and Air Giveaway. Chad Miller and Lisa Calhoun have won free River Dragons merchandise after registering to win at airforceheatingandair.com/dragons. That's airforceheatingandair.com/dragons. Register today and you could be our next winner. Here's Storge Hanner out, far side of the net. Puts it in front, right in on goal. Nitschko the save. Faceoff will come to his left. And again, we do want to remind everybody about the diaper drive going on. Support the Junior League of Columbus by bringing a donation of diapers or baby wipes. And you can meet River Dragons players at the same time at WTVM on Wednesday, February 22nd, noon to 6:30. Drop off your donation right at the station. Maybe grab a selfie with your favorite players. And larger sizes of diapers are in high demand. King's going to put it ahead to Kelly, and here come the River Dragons. Left side, Kelly pushing wide, stops, tried to toe drag his way in. Puck drifts in on goal, and it's held there. 6:11 to go in the second. Let's take a break. 10 seconds along the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2, Fort Benning South, Columbus, and
Imagine being able to be magically whisked away to Delaware. Hi. I'm in Delaware.
Face off back to the right of the Delaware net. Long shot coming in, waved at by Ozalinch. Puck ends up in the near side corner. Nice job on the YouTube side there, Brandon, of getting that Delaware slide up there. I love that clip. Absolutely love it. Well, Wayne's World, one of my favorites. Storage of hand over to the right. He'll stop on the right half wall into the high slot. Kelly. Ozalinch in, his shot blocked. Puck sitting there. Kelly now dangles backdoor feed. Shot, no! What a stop there! Rebound! And a diving block by Wilson on that chance for King. Back comes Delaware the other way with a tip in from Milushkin. Couldn't get it on net. Well, at first, a remarkable save by Nitschko, and then Wilson dove to keep one out, and there's a chance in front. They score. It's Venstrom who puts one home through the wickets on Colgan. And Delaware comes back down after a big save, an even bigger shot block. And they're within one. So that's Ole Venstrom's fifth goal of the year. Belushkin, the only assist on the goal. It jumped into Venstrom's arms. You'd have thought they won the cup. Long shot in on Colgan. He'll catch that one and hold. Right with 5 minutes left to go with the second period. River Dragons with a 2-1 lead on the Thunder. We'll take a break and come right back with more in a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
So you've got projects to do around your home. You got Harvey Lumber for that. You've decided to finally get that large deck built in the back for family fun and entertaining like you've been dreaming about for so long. You got Harvey Lumber for that. From replacing a few boards to replacing all the windows to building from the ground up, you've got Harvey Lumber for that. It's kind of like that old saying, there's an app for that. Well, whatever you need in the way of building supplies, there's been a Harvey Lumber for that in the Chattahoochee Valley for over 150 years. Harvey Lumber Company, 815th Street, open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5.
Back here at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you. Faceoff coming up to the left of the River Dragons net. Brendan Colgan has his team in front 2-1, but the Thunder scoring the most recent goal. And they're hanging in there. I'm calling them the pesky Delaware Thunder because they are pesky. They hang around, they hang around, they hang around. And you have to beat these guys. They are not going to roll over. Even though last night was 9-0, they did not roll over. Did they lose? Yes. But they didn't quit.
Let's go, Dragons!
River Dragons win the faceoff and look to move it out to center. Here's Petrantonio up the left side into the high slot. Underwood, right side of wrist shot, save made. Rebound Doe. Underwood trying to walk it in front. Poked away. Petrantonio in the slot. His shot is stick to the corner. He goes after the rebound, battling with Hanakainen. Comes up the near side wall to the left point. LaBelle, his shot in, tipped in, goes out of play. Right in front of the Delaware goal, ending up in the netting. 4:31 to go in the second period, brought to you by Kinetic Credit Union. Coming up in the second period intermission, we'll have the saves of the week. We'll look at the out-of-town scoreboard presented by Zelmo's Zip-In. Zelmos is also the official fuel provider of the Columbus River Dragons. Of course, we'll wrap up the scoring for the period for you as well. We got at least a couple goals to tell you about, three so far. It's 2-1. River Dragons in the lead. Delaware able to move it out of the zone. Here comes Milushkin. He had it swatted away by Greco. They'll go to the corner together. Tied up over there on the far side. Venstrom back to Milushkin in the corner. Milushkin near side. Wilson feeds it in front. Greco tipped it away. Venstrom tried to center. Put it right to Greco. Puck at the side of the net. Colgan wanted it. Couldn't reach it. Milushkin in the left side half wall. Fed down into the corner. Venstrom tried to center. And again, that hit Greco. Played around to the near side. Wilson, quick centering feed. Off the stick of LaBelle. LaBelle to center. His pass pinballed back. Wickline will tip it down. No icing. River Dragons chasing it along. Daniluk playing it on the left side. Jemayev cutting it off. Jemayev slot. Aldworth right side. Wick line. Put himself out of a shooting position. Then he tried to center and the pass tipped out. Now up with it. Grant Mentis on the right wing side. Backed up by Rogers. His shot off the stick of Rogers and wide. Vanelli tried to work it around quickly there, but it was cut off. Vanelli sweeps it away to an open wing. Rogers shoulder Grant Mentis off the puck. Backhands it ahead, and now King digging for it. Albrecht going to the net. King looking to get it to him in the backhand. Pass defended there nicely by the stick of Oganisov. Now Grant Mentis back on the right side. Into space looking for Delaney. Got it on goal. That forced a save from Colgan, and he hangs on. Faceoff will come up to the left of the Columbus goal. Tom Callahan here with you, broadcasting live from the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Delaney in for the draw across from Storjahan. One back to Vanelli. He'll swing it around to the far side. King chipping it off the dasher. Down, Storjahan chasing. Beat to it by Hanakainen. Delaware once again trying to get to the attack. Delaney on the right wing. Looking to swing it in front. He was cut off. Delaney back on it, right side, side of the net. Volpe trying to jam the goal, left pad save, puck still free. And into the near side corner, Kelly flips it to the line, glove down and kept in. Ends up with Grant Mentis on the right side. Volpe trying to shove it short side, poked away. And now Rogers lost a stick, puck in front, they score. And Delaware's tied this game on a goal by Grant Mentis. A quick one-timer from the slot of a 2:13 left to go. An incredibly shorthanded Delaware Thunder team just will not go away. So over the former River Dragon, Marquis Grant Mentis, that is his second goal of the season. And Columbus is just taking his foot off the gas here. There's no other real explanation for it. So Columbus looking for a little pushback here. They'll move in on the left side. Doe had it popped up in the air. Nobody knew where it was for a moment. Wilson found it in his skates and sent it out. Now back into Petrantonio. Right side. Tried to push ahead for it. Tipped away and now a race for it. Frazier back after it. Venstrom shouldered off by Ozelinch. And now the River Dragons quickly on the rejoinder here. Petrantonio right side with a wrist shot. Blocker save there. Rebound right up the slot. Nobody there for it. Venstrom at center. Puts it right onto the tape of Frazio while Delaware changes. There's a stretch ahead. Pulled down by Costello. He'll leave it. Ozelinch right side. Thought he had Doe, and instead Doe was changing. That's an icing call against the River Dragons with 1:19 to go here in the second period. Grant Mentis, the goal at 17:46, assists going to Volpe and Delaney. And again, the pesky Thunder continue to hang around. Face off to the right of that River Dragons net. Volpe centering feed. That one's going to go all the way out of the zone. At center, Hanakainen will turn it back in. Around it goes onto the far side. Frazier over after it. They'll play it up the wall. Off of Wickline, it kicks right to Aldworth. Aldworth moving in right wing, leaving. Wickline, Aldworth in front for Jemayev. He couldn't get a stick on it. Aldworth, side of the net to Wickline. Backhand feed in front, poked away by the goal stick of Nidchenko. And now Aldworth pulled down. Penalty coming up against Delaware. So the River Dragons are going to pick up a power play here with 47 seconds left to go in the second period. If you can believe it or not, after the first period we had, this is the first penalty call of the second period. And it's Austin Weber into the box. River Dragons back onto the Georgia power play with a roll for two. But boy, Columbus would love to pop one here, get back in the lead, grab that momentum, headed into the locker room. You really have to deflate the balloon here for Delaware because they're going to keep getting up off the mat. You have to knock them out. Puck to the right point. Frazio, left side. Here's Austin Doe. His wrist shot saved, made, and held by Nidchenko. Faceoff will be to his right. It's Jemayev, Doe, Aldworth, Frazio, and Wickline out for the River Dragons on this power play unit. It's in over to the near wall. Aldworth quickly. Right point, Frazio. Left side, Doe to the middle of the ice. Wanted a seam, couldn't find one. Leaves it off. Aldworth circling, cutting to his right. Puts it in front. Oh, Jemaev just missed the tip, going for between the legs there. Bouncing puck towards the left point. Doe, help keeping it in. Aldworth, left side, Jemaev. Across the ice quickly to Wickline. Wickline to the right half wall with it. Wickline swings it between the D and out of the zone. That might do it for the period here. Under 10 seconds to go now. Doe back with it. River Dragons going to try to push in. Here's Jemaev moving in, leaving it off. 2 seconds. Can Albert get a shot away? And not in time. So the River Dragons will carry over. 1 minute, 14 seconds of power play continuation into the third. But this game is tied up at 2. And boy, if you're the Delaware Thunder, you've got to feel excellent about where you are and how you have battled in this hockey game despite being extremely shorthanded personnel-wise. 40 minutes in, each team has scored twice. So we're going to take a break. When we come back, we will have our second intermission brought to you by Shred Away. We have our saves of the week coming up in just a little bit. So stay tuned for those as well, which are presented by Kinetic Credit Union. We have a wrap on the scoring for you, plus that look at the out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by Zelmo's Zip-In. And we will be right back with more in just a moment. It's time to check the pucks here at the Columbus Civic Center. And on the broadcast side, it's time to pay the bills. We'll be back 2-2 after 2. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Now Greco with a punishing hit on the far side, but 2-on-1 the other way. Him with a chance. Save Colgan. He paddles a rebound away. Back in the right wing, here's Butina trying to push in behind the D, and coming to his right, Pavlos, a big save on Butina.
3.
Kennedy, right point, with a roller, feeds it back down towards near side. Sends it right in front, off the defender, puck still free, chance diving to his left, Colgan the save.
2.
Backhand on the near side, banks it back up, Kennedy at the right point, he'll let a wrister go, Pavlos save, rebound, Pavlos, a glove save. And he will hang on.
1.
Salak. Salak forced off by King. He tries to get backdoor shot. Left pad save. Pavlos, what a stop on Berth.
Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
Heroes of Valhalla is your go-to place for all of your gunsmithing and firearms needs. They also specialize in Cerakote finishing as well as hydro dipping, which offers over 1,000 different pattern options. Check them out online at heroesofvalhalla.us or stop by the shop at 6320 Bradley Park Drive in Columbus. They're open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Online at heroesofvalhalla.us. Craving a burrito, some nachos, or maybe even a quesadilla? Head to Barberitos. Their menu includes only the freshest ingredients, and your order is custom-made how you want it on the spot. Barberitos is founded on freshness, and everything from our handmade guacamole to our marinades are made right in-house. And don't forget, you can order online at barberitos.com or through our handy mobile app. Barberitos. Food. Community. People.
Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain is your trusted plumber in Columbus and beyond. We go the extra mile to show up on time, diagnose your situation quickly, and get to the root of the problem. Blue Frog is here to deliver the right solution the first time, and we're available 24/7 because plumbing emergencies don't keep office hours. Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain. Less mess, less stress. On the web at bluefrogplumbing.com or call 706-887-6433.
Oral and maxillofacial surgeons Mark Sawicki, Lee Allen practice a traditional scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery with over 60 years of combined expertise, ranging from oral pathology to wisdom tooth removal. They perform a full range of dental implant and bone grafting procedures, as well as non-invasive surgical facial cosmetic procedures. That level of expertise is why the River Dragons trust them. Call them in Columbus at 596-1757 or in LaGrange at 884-2655.
Everybody out here crazy.
Hello everyone and welcome back here on Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Tom Callahan here with you, and we're in the Shredaway second intermission report. The River Dragons right now tied up at two with the Delaware Thunder, and all credit to the Thunder for the period they had there. Kept losing bodies. By the end of the period, they were down to 8 healthy forwards, 4 defensemen, yet they kept plugging away, managed to turn a 2-0 deficit into a 2-2 tie at the end of the period. And right now, if you're Delaware, you're in that locker room thinking you have a very real chance to come out with some points. Meanwhile, for the River Dragons, they clinched a playoff spot last night, but again, that doesn't mean take your foot off the gas. There's plenty of hockey left to be played here, a couple of months left to go in this FPHL season. And for the River Dragons, you know you're facing a shorthanded team, but they're a dangerous team. They don't quit. They keep coming at you. They just keep grinding it away. And if you take your foot off the gas for any point in time, you know that they're going to go right back after you. And that's what we saw, I think, in the second period. The Thunder continued to fight back. Now, the River Dragons will start with a minute and 14 seconds of power play time to open period number three. So that definitely on their side. And for the River Dragons right now, cashing in on that power play, while important, and it would be great to get a 3-2 lead off that Georgia Power power play, not necessarily the point. What the point of, for me, that minute 14 seconds is, the River Dragons need to get the momentum. They need to reestablish their foothold on this game. They need to show Delaware that in this third period it's going to be all River Dragons all the time. We're closing out the series at home. And look, I understand, and everyone understands, these two teams are tired. They both played 3 games in 3 days here. It has at times been a physical series. Last night was certainly an emotional win for the River Dragons. Sold out crowd, a lot of energy, a lot of everything going around yesterday. It's natural there could be a little bit of a letdown. But the River Dragons have definitely had their scoring chances here today. And if they continue to press, and really most importantly, two things, face-offs and the battles. They can win the battles in the corners, whether in the offensive or defensive zone, come out with the puck more often than not, then the River Dragons are going to win this hockey game. And that's something for us to keep an eye on here in period number three as well. So they're chucking the pucks down on the ice here at the Columbus Civic Center. We are going to go back to break. When we come back, we'll have a look at the Zelmo Zippin out-of-town scoreboard for you, plus a wrap of the scoring, 4 goals to tell you about, and we'll do that when we come back in just a moment. This is the Shredaway second intermission report, 2-2 after 2 on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons, Country Inn and Suites by Radisson.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat-pressed lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
At Mr. Sparky, we're America's on-time electrician. We all count on our home's electrical outlets to provide us the power we need when we need it. But sometimes an overloaded circuit can lead to a blown outlet. So leave it to the pros at Mr. Sparky. We'll get it done right and get it done safely. Call now for $50 off electrical repairs.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8 Sparky.
Sparky. Limitations and restrictions may apply. Independently owned and operated. Licensed in the respective state or county.
Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain is your trusted plumber in Columbus and beyond. We go the extra mile to show up on time, diagnose your situation quickly, and get to the root of the problem. Blue Frog is here to deliver the right solution the first time. And we're available 24/7 because plumbing emergencies don't keep office hours. Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain. Less mess, less stress. On the web at bluefrogplumbing.com or call 706-887-6433.
In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We're proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
With you. Thanks for joining us as we are in the Shuttleway second intermission reports. And we're going to take a look inside the numbers of the scoring and give you an update here. And I'm actually going to do the Zelmo's Zipping Out of Town scoreboard last because we're down to 13 laps to go at Daytona. We've just gone green. I'll tell you about what's going on there later. But again, if you're at the game or you're listening or you're out traveling and you don't want to know what's going on, I'll give you the heads up before I give you the full update on that one. Let's take a look and wrap up the scoring here for you from that second period of play where all the goals happened. And for the River Dragons, they ended up scoring the first two goals. And it started 8:09 of the first period. Columbus gets on the board. Josh Petrantonio at 8:09, an even strength marker with assists going to Austin Doe and Kirk Underwood. Boy, it's so good to see that line clicking. Those guys are really doing a super job right now and look absolutely fantastic together. The last couple of games, they're kind of putting it back together. And Petrantonio's talked about he's found the spark again, feeling a little bit better. We talked to Josh during the first period intermission last night. And it really meant, a lot, I'm sure, to his teammates and to him to, you know, be able to kind of find that rejuvenation. And look, it's a long hockey season. These guys go through ups and downs. There are going to be lulls. There are going to be moments when you just don't want to get out of bed in the morning because something hurts. And everybody goes through it over the course of a season. But Petrantonio has found that fire. And he scores again here, his 11th of the year from Doe and Underwood at 8:09. Then just 11 seconds later at 8:20, Alexander Jemayev cashes in a goal-mouth pass from Thomas Aldworth. And Jemayev back in the lineup after missing a couple of games, speaking of bumps and bruises. His 10th from Aldworth and Wickline at 8:20. And the River Dragons look like they were poised to really blow this one open, much the way they did last night. But the Thunder hang around. And as the Thunder lost some more bodies, they seem to get a little bit better. At 14:38, Venstrom scores his 5th of the year from Milushkin as he puts one away from in tight. That makes it 2-1. And then it's 17:47, almost a carbon copy goal as the former River Dragon Marquise Grant Mentis with a goal from the slot, just his 2nd of the year from Wolf and Delaney at 17:47. This game's tied. Now the River Dragons carry over 1 minute 14 seconds of power play time here. But boy, oh boy, right now, Delaware, if they can make it through 20 minutes with however many guys are going to make it back onto that bench and at least get it past regulation, they're stealing points. Absolutely stealing points. The River Dragons need to come out and just have an incredible third period here. They need to play hard, and they really need to just take things down as best as they can and make it work. Can they do it? Can they put everything together? I think so. I believe so. We're going to find out. Okay, so now as, well, shots on goal in the period, want to tell you that as well, 19-9 in favor of the River Dragons, 31-18 for the hockey game. And each team did score twice. No power plays in that period officially. The River Dragons, as I told you, were carrying overtime. So really, both teams zeros in that second. They both remain 0-2. River Dragons heading on to chance number 3 here with a minute 14 seconds left to go in that tripping call that Weber picked up at the end of the period. All right, time for the Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard. Zelmo's has been fueling life's passions since 1999. And over at First Arena in Elmira, New York, that's the only other game that was going on earlier today between the Watertown Wolves and the Elmira Mammoth. And, of course, now that I want to give you the score, I can't. Try to find out what happened in this one. It was tied at one. Well, the entire sheet of match. Oh, there we go. There's an overtime goal credited to Samuel Rabchick. And it looks like it is a victory. Well, let's see here. Let me make sure I got this right. Okay, it is indeed Watertown that wins. Watertown wins it in overtime. Rabchick the goal. 4:27 into the 5-minute OT. Watertown with a big victory right there. Those two teams are nip-tuck in the standings. In the NHL, Maple Leafs and Blackhawks halfway through the first period. There is no score in that one. Later on, you got Jets at Devils, Blue Jackets at Coyotes. Finals from earlier today, Wild 4-3 over the Predators. The Senators, 7-2 winners over the St. Louis Blues. And it took overtime, but the Colorado Avalanche pulled it out against the Edmonton Oilers, 6-5. Mikko Rantanen's 36th goal of the year. That is the decider for Colorado. Okay, let's check back in here on Daytona and give me a moment to get squared away here, and I will give you what's going on in just a moment. Okay, so if you don't want to know what's going on, give me just one moment here, and let me make sure this leaderboard is updated first before I actually start giving it to you. Okay, here we go. I'm going to give you the what's going on right now here in 3-2-1. Six laps to go. Brad Keselowski is in the lead. Buescher second. Busch third. Dillon fourth. Byron fifth. Stenhouse Jr. sixth. Logano, Cindric, Bell, and Larson round out the top 10. Six to go. They are green at Daytona. All right, there you go. There was your very quick update. Believe it or not, the leaderboard is actually behind the internet broadcast, and that doesn't happen very often. But seems like it's just one of those days, right? It's a Sunday, time ticking down. If we do get a race winner, again, I'll warn you before I tell you who it is. But now I'm going to warn you, we're going to break. That's the end of the Shredaway second period intermission report. When we come back, third period action coming your way, tied at two. Thunder and River Dragons through 40 minutes. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Shredaway, a division of the Overbee Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overbee Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
River Dragons Hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like chuck-a-pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon, fiberglass, and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner. Cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside. Technology with a human touch.
Hey Columbus River Dragons fans, I'm meteorologist Elise Ushman in the WTVM Storm Team 9 Alert Center with a look at your forecast. After the game tonight, we're going to be seeing temperatures into the mid-50s overnight, and as you head out the door tomorrow, into the mid-40s. Monday is going to be another partly cloudy day. Temperatures even warmer into the mid-70s. A really pleasant start to our work week, and this warming trend is going to continue as we go through the rest of the week. Overnight Monday, temperatures will stay in the upper 50s. For Tuesday afternoon, we'll be closer to the 80-degree mark, and we'll start to see a chance at a shower or two. That slim chance at a shower will stick around through the end of the work week, and by the weekend, we should see a little bit more sunshine. Temperatures every single day will stay in the low 80s. Wednesday through Sunday, we'll see a change in this pattern as we get into the very next work week, temperatures back into the 70s. We'll be right back on the Columbus River Dragons Broadcast Network.
Back here, looking forward to third period action at the Columbus Civic Center. River Dragons and the Delaware Thunder tied up at two apiece. I'll give you an update on the Daytona 500 in just a little bit here, but not right now. We'll get to it. Third period brought to you by IGH Properties. It is the final period of the weekend. 3-3 for the River Dragons, trying to get through this final 20 minutes. NASCAR celebrating its 75th anniversary this year. Starting out with the big one here, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. As both teams are getting ready to come back on the ice, I'm interested to see exactly how many Delaware Thunder players make it back out. They have had such a rough afternoon. They lost a couple players earlier on to injury. Lopsa left the ice. Haven't seen him come back. Gafarov left early in the first. Asp also left, hasn't come back. It's been a rough night for Hanakainen, but he's hanging on. And I'm not entirely sure if they are going to be able to bring out any of those players, bring them back, but they were down to basically four defense and eight forwards, plus a backup goalie. You might be looking at Trevor Martin saying, hey man, you want to play D, throw some shin pads on? All right, real quick, before we start the period, I'm going to tell you what's going on in the Daytona 500. Give me just about 30 seconds here. In 3, 2, 1. They're going to overtime. Yes, NASCAR has overtime. The Daytona 500 is going there after a crash. Kyle Busch is leading right now. Dylan, Byron, Logano, Keselowski, the top five. 18th start without a win for Kyle Busch. Only Dale Earnhardt had more starts before his first win. He had 20. All right, that's it. Done talking about the 500 for now. At least until we get a race result. Tied at two between the Thunder and the River Dragons. We're set to open period number three. Is it actually possible? Let's see here. I think the Thunder lost another player in the intermission. Because they've got one in the penalty box, which is Weber. They have five guys now on the ice and six on the bench. So they have 12 skaters left. Oh, yeah, no, that's right. 4D, eight forwards. Wow. The fact that the Thunder are hanging around in this hockey game and it's 2-2 right now. Really impressive. All right. right, so 1 minute, 14 seconds of power play time for the River Dragons to start period number three, brought to you by IGH Properties. River Dragons start with possession of the draw, and they'll look to move it ahead here. Boy, Columbus would really like to get this power play goal here as they walk in, look to set it up. Right side half ball, here's King. King up top, LaBelle. King, top of the near dot, LaBelle high slot, over to the far side, doesn't shoot. Chance in front, a bouncer side of the net, and that is covered up and held by Nedjeko. It is Greco, LaBelle, Storjahan, King, and Kelly out on this power play. 50-5-0, seconds left to go. And the man advantage, Georgia power play. Puck to the point, kept in left point. It's sent over to the right side to Kelly. Nice keep there by LaBelle. Here's Storjahan wailing at the top of the near circle. His wrist shot through traffic, and it did not. Well, LaBelle with his chance, that missed. Stays behind the net on the rebound. King over after it. Left point, LaBelle. LaBelle fakes, now lets it go off the outside of the cage. Kelly tried to scoop it up on a stick blade and toss it in. Couldn't quite get it to go. But the power play time is going to wind down. The Thunder kill it off. So the River Dragons 0-3 with a Georgia power play. And it stays tied at 2 to start things off. Here's Greco, right side. Oh, that is way offside. That offside brought to you by Old School Barber Shop. Online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. You can book online anytime, and you can book 24/7 through their Instagram and their Facebook. I'm going to tell you, simple process. I did it the other day. Made an appointment, went down. Barber did a great job on my hair. Can't complain. Booked it all online. Text updates. Anything you want, man. It's great. Easy setup. So if your sides are a little off, go see Old School Barbershop. Delaware working it back into the right side. There's a shot in on goal. That is blocked away to the near side glass by Colgan. And that one's sent around out of play. And again, all credit to Delaware. Still in this one. It's 2-2. They've got a short bench. They're just kind of rotating through guys. They're sticking around. Face off to the right of Colgan. Frazio puts it around to the far side out through center. Here's Underwood after it. And now into the corner. Here goes Underwood trying to find out what's going on the left side. He's unable to keep it in. That one deflects off Petrantonio. Wow, there it is. It finally came down at center. Petrantonio right back in with it. He'll turn it in. Off the outside of the net, Petrantonio behind the Delaware goal. Into the right side corner. Here's Doe. Frazio down for the right point. Frazio to the far side. Set up top. Ozolinch lets it go. Blocker save. Rebound to the far side. Petrantonio ties it up for a moment. Now a chance to clear. Delaware trying to get it out. Up the left side, driving in on goal. Delaney, he is shut down nicely there by Brendan Colgan. Now back is Allworth with speed. Allworth cutting to the backhand. He couldn't get through. Tried to send it down low, looking for Jemea. Quickline pulls it out of the pile. Centering attempt there. Cleared away to the line, not out. Vanelli holding it in. There's a feed in front. Pinballs towards the point, and it's pushed out by Delaware. Here's Rogers looping up the left side, 3:05 into the third. Tied at 2, Delaware and Columbus. Jemaev into the slot. It comes to the right wing, picked up by Wickline. His shot in on goal, save Nedjeko, and he holds on to the rebound. Faceoff will remain in the Delaware zone to the left of the Thunder netminder. Again, hasn't played much this year. He's appeared in 6 games with only 1 decision. But he has played very well here this afternoon, as is Brendan Colgan. Puck is kept in by the River Dragons. Here's King in the right side corner. King at the dot. Right point, Rogers. His wrists are well wide. King onto the left half wall. Kelly into the corner. Storjahan backhand in front. That one is tipped away by the goal stick of Nedjeko. And Hanakainen will loop back with it. Up the left side boards out to center. Chance now, Venstrom playing it ahead, looking for Milushkin. Milushkin trying to shake his check, ends up in the corner after trying to skip around Rogers. Here's a centering feed, and Wilson had his stick tied up in front, now away. Here comes Kelly. Left side, looking to feed it in front. Couldn't get it through to Vanelli, and now a player ends up knocking the net off. As that was Wilson who went sliding into it and behind the play, I believe. Or, no, pardon me, that was Oganazov. By the way, the faceoff will stay inside the Delaware Thunder zone. Petrantonio out there along with Doe and Chuck Costello. LaBelle and Greco on the points here. A day off for Jay Krupp today. Not in the lineup. Well, they didn't like that. Petrantonio never even put his stick down. And the puck was put down by the linesman. And the puck back to the point. Greco with a shot that missed the net. Left side here's Doe. Petrantonio in the corner. Petrantonio on the left half wall. And now it's cleared away by Delaware. 2-2 tie on our hands here. 4.5 minutes into this third period. And now Delaware has to give the puck up at the line because they were offside. There's a stretch pass in the wing and hooked up there fighting his way in Petrantonio. The wave off icing. Petrantonio gets to it. Sends it up top. A shot save made. Rio Costello couldn't get his stick free to shoot. Doe had a great attempt from the far side. Petrantonio in that near side corner. Has to bounce off a check. Doe after it. Costello in the circle. Trying to battle his way free. Kicks it over to the wall and it's backhanded out to center. River Dragons turn with it. Here's Costello. Left wing side. He'll chip it into the corner. Greco moves up on the forecheck here. And he's going to finish his check there on Daniluk. Right point, Aldworth. Aldworth to the right half wall. Greco. Greco. Pass to the slot. Tumbles over to the far side. Jemayev on it. Jemayev up top. Backs up. Flips it into space. Cut off by Delaware. They just wedge it out down the ice. Played with a high stick, and so the faceoff will come back into the River Dragons end of things here. When we come back, 5:37 gone in the third, tied at 2, Thunder and River Dragons. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
IGH Properties specializes in managing single-family homes, single condos, entire HOAs, small and large apartments, and commercial business properties in the Chattahoochee Valley and beyond. Their expert property management team takes on the day-to-day chores of managing your rental property so you can enjoy a successful investment. Some of the responsibilities they handle are marketing, tenant interactions, lease agreements, and more. See them at IGHproperties.net. That's IGHproperties.net. IGH Properties. Happy tenants, happy owners, better rentals.
So, you've got projects to do around your home. You got Harvey Lumber for that. You've decided to finally get that large deck built in the back for family fun and entertaining like you've been dreaming about for so long. You got Harvey Lumber for that. From replacing a few boards to replacing all the windows to building from the ground up, you've got Harvey Lumber for that. It's kind of like that old saying, there's an app for that. Well, whatever you need in the way of building supplies, there's been a Harvey Lumber for that in the Chattahoochee Valley for over 150 years. Harvey Lumber Company, 815th Street, open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5.
We are back here in the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Tom Callahan here with you. Third period action, 5:37 gone in the third. Want to say a special hello to my buddy Tommy Keeling tuning us in. Say hello to Tommy, Patty, and Drew. Face off to the right of Brennan Colgan. Draw coming up here in just a moment. And the captain, Josh Petrantonio, in to take it. He wins it back. Frazio works it out that left side. We're skating 5-on-5 here. Tied at 2. Both teams scored both goals in the second period. River Dragons had their pair 11 seconds apart. It went from scoreless to 2-0 very quickly, Petrantonio and Jemayev. But Delaware clawed its way back in. They ended up scoring twice before the end of the frame, despite having a short bench, Venstrom and Grant Mentis. That's how we got here. So now, River Dragons trying to apply some pressure, but Delaware able to move the puck out. And again, Delaware, if they can get through the next 13 and change here, will absolutely steal a point, if not more. Here's Petrantonio in front to Wickline, and it rolled on him. He ended up punching it wide. 6.5 into the third, tied at 2. Milushkin dumps it in behind the River Dragons net. Colgan will leave it there. Sent around the right side. Wickline tipped to the line. Not out. Held in by Daniluk. Rogers curls back in the right wing. Wickline, a backhand chip. Looking ahead in space for Aldworth, but sent right back into the Columbus end. River Dragons on the left wing. That one is dumped deep. Daniluk will be beaten to the puck by Aldworth. Aldworth had his pass for Wickline deflected around, though. And ahead to center. Here's Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis on the right side, getting it into space for Wilson. Off-angle chance, save Colgan. Rebound swatted away to center now. A race, here's Aldworth. Moving up, he's got help. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Left it for Wickline. Wickline tied up from behind. Vanelli continuing the play on a backhand chance. Save made, rebound right through the goal crease. Onto the right wing, here's Jemayev all the way up with a point. Vanelli on the right half wall, knows he has help in the corner, gets it to Wickline. Wickline right side into the slot, a shot, save made, rebound, and the puck is cleared back out to center. Nedchenko with a huge stop. Venstrom leaves it off, Grant Mentis back to Venstrom, backdoor feed, they score! Grant Mentis again! The Delaware Thunder incredibly have taken a 3-2 lead. Grant Mentis showing up against his former team. 7:45, time of the goal. Colgan goes over to the bench and actually has one of his pads almost all the way off as he's redoing something to do with the skate lace and a fastener there, the toe strap. We're going to have a little delay while he fixes that. This is as good as a timeout right now for the River Dragons. Also a chance to kind of get things together here. They're down 3-2. And Delaware, again, despite the record, dangerous because they don't quit. They keep coming at you. And again, short bench. They've got 4 defensemen. And they've got 8 forwards right now. And it's been a war of attrition. Columbus, meanwhile, has to be shaking its head a little bit. So Grant Mentis has 2. Right now, he's given the Delaware Thunder a 3-2 lead. Only assist on the goal goes to Venstrom. By the way, the Daytona 500 is still not finished. You've been waiting, and I told you I wouldn't give you an update till there was a result. I guess that's kind of an update. Still not over. All right, River Dragons have their work cut out for them. They need not one, but 2 now. 3-2 Delaware. Let's see if the River Dragons can figure it out. Here's King. He'll swing it back to Greco inside his own end. King with a stretch pass. Wanted Kelly at center. Couldn't get it to him. Instead, it's bounced back in on Colgan, who has to cover as it disappeared in his gear. And Wolf goes in and snows Colgan, and Greco does not like that. Wolf did exactly the same thing yesterday and drew this exact reaction for it. Colgan is still messing around with that right pad. He does not like something going on. Giving a look at his right skate. Not entirely sure what the story is. I don't know if it's maybe the steel is bothering him, or perhaps, I know that there's times if you don't tie off your toe strap correctly, especially if you use a skate lace interface for the pad with the skate, it can get in the way. Left side, River Dragons breaking back in. Here's a backdoor pass for Kelly. It was up in the air, though, and he tried to knock it down. Couldn't put it home. Back the other way. It's sent in from center. Venstrom sending it around, and it'll be left Greco. Onto the right wing side, trying to punch it ahead. A hit King came back to Storjahan. Kelly tipping it on. LaBelle. LaBelle steps up with it. LaBelle with a nifty move. He's up one-on-one with a wrist shot. That one up high on Nichenko. And it rattled him a little bit, but he's all right. Back the other way. River Dragons trying to move ahead. And now here we go back in the zone. We get a penalty coming up. That one is going to be against the Delaware Thunder. Looks like Milushkin's going to draw a call. River Dragons have the extra man out there. Here's Petrantonio, right side. Puck caroms to Greco. A shot. Save made. And he goes looking for a rebound. And some pushing and shoving in front. Greco looks like he's just over there playing whack-a-mole as a white jersey comes over. He tries to get a shot at it. Hopefully the River Dragons don't give away a power play here, because they need it. It'll be their fourth Georgia power play of the night. They're 0 for 3. Last night, 2 for 5. Shots 40 for the River Dragons, 22 for the Thunder. Yet the Thunder are finding their way to stick around. 9:17, time of the penalty against Danila Milushkin. I didn't see the indication. Let's see here. Elbowing is what we have. Drawn to the left of the Delaware Thunder net, Wick line. Jemayev Aldworth, Rogers, Austin Doe. That's your power play unit, although stepping ahead with the puck and now sending it down the ice is Wolf. So the River Dragons have to chase it 200 feet to start this power play. Wolf throws a big hit on Aldworth. Wilson into the left side corner. Finally, the puck turned over, and now ahead, Aldworth, right side to Wickline. Wickline moving in, back to Aldworth, too far on the send. Jemayev, left side corner, cycles it to Aldworth. Aldworth, left point, sent over to the right now. Rogers, back up top to Doe. Doe doesn't shoot. Scoots left, now Rogers walks in. Near dot, Wickline had it roll off his stick. The feed to the corner. In front, chance, and off the stick of Doe, and out of the zone it goes. Past the halfway mark of this third period, 3-2 Delaware. Wickline in, backdoor feed into the skates of Jemayev. No way he could pick it out to shoot, and it's cleared. 1 minute to go on the power play. Wickline waiting in the blue line, cuts back into the right side. Wickline moving in, and it's cleared away. The River Dragons couldn't take advantage. One of the Delaware players had to crawl to the bench after he lost the steel out of his skate. Delaney in with a long shot, pawed down by Colgan. Puck is free on the near side. And now back ahead is LaBelle leading the charge. He'll walk it in himself and stop there on the boards, but Delaney right there, he had to feed it to the side of the net. Greco tried to power his way free. Instead, it's sent around to the wall left side. Ivanov can't clear. Right point, here's LaBelle. LaBelle with a shot, tipped in front, rebound, sitting there, and no! How did it not go in? Unbelievable! Lane King doesn't know how he didn't score a goal there. Unreal. Delaware just getting either shot blocks or big saves at the right time. River Dragons back in. Power play ticks down. King, slot, shot, he ripped it high. Puck bounces off the back of the net. Played around past Storjahan to the right point. Frazio back to 5-on-5. Behind the net, chased by Greco. King, left side corner. Storjahan on the near side. King fell, lost the puck. Hanakainen out with it. He tried to clear, but it's tipped and stays in. Here's Storjahan, right side in. Backdoor feed, a shot! Save made, coming to his right by Nichenko. And we get a whistle, an interference call. And when we come back, River Dragons will go back on the power play, trailing 3-2, 8:19 to go in the third. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Sound anywhere. It's the crisp crunch of that first nacho chip. With its perfect cheese to sour cream ratio sitting atop a layer of delicious beans, it's a sip away from perfection. That's what we're looking for. Add a delicious, refreshing Pepsi and we've achieved absolute nacho nirvana. Because while you can pile those nachos high with every spicy, cheesy, savory topping, there's no topping a cool Pepsi finish. Nachos, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
When the River Dragons have a breakdown, the puck can end up in the back of the net. But when your car has a breakdown, you need a reliable tow partner. Trust the tow company the River Dragons depend on, Tuffy's Towing. Tuffy's tows many types of vehicles in the Chattahoochee Valley. Call 706-457-0985 for a quote or go online to tuffystowing.com. Tuffy's, we tow more than just cars.
Back at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you in the IGH Properties third period. And we finally have a winner in the Daytona 500. And if you want me to tell you who it is, I'll tell you in 3, 2, 1. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. has won the Daytona 500 finally. Wow, took a long time to get there. But the River Dragons now back on the Georgia Power power play. Interference, the call against Hanakainen. Petrantonio feeding it up top as the River Dragons possess. Frazio over to the left side. Fed back across Frazio. His shot in and a glove save there by Nichenko. He will hold on. Now 8:01 to go here in the third period. Interference call came at 11:41. River Dragons' fifth power play of the evening. They are 0-4. Columbus controlling the draw. Frazio with a long shot, tip down in front. Here's Austin Doe, side of the net. Underwood over to the far side with it. He'll get it up top, and it scoots off the stick of Vanelli and away to center. So Columbus must regroup. Here's Doe looking across the ice to Vanelli. He picks it up off the dasher. Up the left side, Vanelli turning it in, but it's sent right back down by Delaware. 1:10 to go on the man advantage. The River Dragons trying to find an answer here on the power play. They'll walk in on the left wing. Pass for Vanelli into the slot. Turned away to the line, but kept in by Jacob Kelly. Kelly on the left side sends it around the rim. It didn't make it to Storjahan. Took a bounce off the puck board and was cleared out by Delaware. Colgan in trouble behind his own net. Gave it away to Weber. Lost his goal stick. And Malushkin just couldn't quite catch up for a shorthanded chance. Back the other way, here's King. Working it in right side. King in front. Storjahan. It bounces wide of the near post. Storjahan, right side, circling with Kelly. Kelly, top of the faceoff. Leaves it up top. LaBelle, his wrister. Shot is blocked away in front. Now a chance in. Kelly to the backhand. Has to fight to get his stick free. Stops behind the net. Sends it out far side. Cross ice quickly. Storjahan, a shot off the outside of the post. Storjahan up top into space for LaBelle. LaBelle rolling puck back to Storjahan. 7 seconds in the power play. Storjahan shot is blocked. LaBelle left side. King looking in front. Curling. Power play's over. Left up for LaBelle. LaBelle to the dot. Far side shot. Nichenko right pad save. LaBelle again looking in front. Plenty. And Kelly's going to drop the gloves. Finally, the frustration with Weber. And Kelly getting some extra shots in there, and now Weber pops back up. He's trying to get in. The lines would get back out of the way. Weber saying, come on, this one's over. But nope, they're going to throw, and now Kelly back in with a couple of rights of his own. Kelly trying to get a body blow in there. And now Weber back with a right. Kelly with one of his own as they're tied up in close, and Kelly switches to the left. Kelly spinning him around. Down they go. That'll take Kelly off the ice for 5 minutes of the remaining 6:09 of this hockey game. And that's a win for Delaware. Leading score for the River Dragons. I know it's tough. You hate to make that trade-off. But now someone's got to step up for Columbus. 3-2, Thunder lead, 6:09 to go into third. It's crunch time here. River Dragons 0-for-5 on the power play. They could not get it to go. There's a puck kept in off the draw. Oselich in the left point, ends up with Aldworth. Aldworth swings it onto the wall. Gets it back in the left half boards. Aldworth into space for Wickline. Can't get a shot away. Wickline tied up by Hanakainen on the far side. Pushed into the slot area. Puck still not out of the zone. Jemayev holding it in. Oselich charging down the left wing. Try to feed it in front. Hit Hanakainen with it. Clear to the line. Not out. Jemayev with a long shot. Blockered away. And it's sent behind the net. Aldworth trying to catch up to it. Oganisov to the far side. Hanakainen tied up. Puck stays in. How much gas do these teams have left? Wraparound attempt by Jemayev. Swung right across the crease. Jemayev's got to be one of the freshest guys out there. This is his first game of the weekend. Milushkin steps up. He gets knocked down. Shot on goal. Save made. Colgan rebound right by the near post. Underwood will pull it back out. He'll move it back for Rogers. And now Columbus under 5 to go in the third. 3-2 Thunder. Underwood on the right side. He'll poke it in off the glass. Slides it into the corner. Doe around after it. Centering feet. Pietrantonio stopped on the doorstep. Big save there, and now 2-on-2 back up the left side. Delaney leading in, cutting to his right. Delaney with a shot, steered it wide. Columbus clearing it out and literally out of play. 4:34 to go in the third. 3-2 Thunder in the lead. We're back with the exciting conclusion of Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Specializes in managing single-family homes, single condos, entire HOAs, small and large apartments, and commercial business properties in the Chattahoochee Valley and beyond. Their expert property management team takes on the day-to-day chores of managing your rental property so you can enjoy a successful investment. Some of the responsibilities they handle are marketing, tenant interactions, lease agreements, and more. See them at IGHproperties.net. That's IGHproperties.net. IGH Properties. Happy tenants, happy owners, better rentals.
Craving a burrito? Some nachos, or maybe even a quesadilla? Head to Barberitos. Their menu includes only the freshest ingredients, and your order is custom made how you want it on the spot. Barberitos is founded on freshness, and everything from our handmade guacamole to our marinades are made right in-house. And don't forget, you can order online at barberitos.com or through our handy mobile app. Barberitos. Food, community, people.
Back here at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you on the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Third period brought to you by IGH Properties. 4:34 to go in the final frame. And the Thunder with a 3-2 lead over the River Dragons. Draw coming up to the right of Brendan Colgan in the Columbus end. 5-on-5. Some of the big numbers in this one. Shots are 47-24 for the River Dragons, yet they trail by a goal. They're also 0-for-5 in the Georgia Power power play here today. Face-off controlled by the River Dragons. Here's Vanelli putting it around under the far side to Doe. Doe looking to move that one out. It's put back into the corner now. Grant Mentis, who has two in the game. Centering feed tipped away off the mid of Underwood. Venstrom a shot, pinballed off the shin pads of Doe to center. Delaware putting it ahead in space on the left side. Vanelli. Underwood can't move it ahead. Vanelli will pull it back. Columbus. Delaware just jamming it up here. One guy in and then four in the neutral zone. Grant Mentis on the other side. And Delaware does not have to be overly aggressive. They can trap to their heart's content here. Petrantonio up the right side in with a wrist shot. Missed on the blocker side. Vanelli, left side corner. Petrantonio. Petrantonio, near side. King on the right half wall. Lets it go to the point. Frazier feeding it back deep. It kicks around and didn't quite make it to Costello. Cleared out of play. Is that going to be a delay game? Call it is. The River Dragons gifted a late power play. Wilson protesting. The referee saying delay of game. He's going to call the other refs over. Well, let's find out. Is it or is it not? Because this is massive. If that's a delay of game, even Weber indicating, of course, he's in the box just kind of saying, nope, tipped, it was tipped. But the River Dragons do not have, nope, delay of game. Hanakainen is protesting as he goes in. But methinks the lady doth protest too much. Delay a game call, 16-29. Sixth power play of the game for the River Dragons. Georgia Power power play, none bigger. Although goals on any of them would count the same, I will point that out. Here we go. River Dragons start by controlling the puck. King getting it up top. Costello tried a shot. That was blocked. And now out to center Delaware. They'll fire it down. Wilson right on Colgan. Colgan's got to play it away to the near corner. Columbus on the regroup. Here's Costello right side in over the line. He'll carry to the right wing corner. Costello tried to hook it up top. It caroms to Greco. Greco behind the net. Greco side of the goal. Oh, if he could have got a shot away. He had an open net, and now the puck rolls past LaBelle down the ice. Colgan's got to come way out to play it ahead to King. King off the skates of Greco. It kicks back to Storjahan. The River Dragons just need to get set up and calm it down here. King tried to force one in front. Came back to him. Left point, LaBelle. There's a shot in on goal. Nitchenko the same, and he holds on. As the puck drops in front of him, 101 left to go in the Georgia Power power play. Delay a game against Hanakainen. Thunder 3, River Dragons 2, 2:32 left to go in the third. Wilson in against Wickline for the draw. Aldworth, Jemayev out there, along with Rogers and Doe. Puck on the dot, tied up. Comes to the left point, Doe holding it in. Over to the right side, here's Rogers. Rogers backs up. Left side to Doe. Doe, wrist shot, and right into the chest protector. Nitchenko will hold. Wickline once again in for the faceoff across from Houston Wilson. Wickline again wins the draw. Aldworth playing catch left side. Doe over the right point. Rogers, his shot off traffic in front wide of the net. Jemayev kicks it to himself out the far side. Left point, Doe. Doe to Rogers. Rogers, Doe, high slot, right side corner, Wickline. Wickline, Rogers lets it go, and that one is knocked out of front. Puck still free. Where is it? It's in somebody's gear. We get a whistle here. 26 seconds to go on the man advantage. Just under 2 minutes to go in the third. And a River Dragons wisely will call a timeout. The Remember, Jacob Kelly is sitting in the box right now. He had a five-minute fighting major at 13:51. So he's not due out until we have a minute, 9 seconds, and a whistle. He and Weber both in the box. Well, you missed not having him on this power play. But right now, head coach Jerome Bichard trying to urge his troops on. Colgan checking in with Boomer to see what time, if he needs to come off, when. 26 seconds to go on the power play. Certainly, if you don't have to, and you're only down by a goal, you don't want to give the Thunder free shots at the empty net with no icing. So for the moment, Colgan stays put, and I imagine he will for at least the duration of the power play. Face off to the left of Nitchenko. Quick line. We'll take the face off again here. They back Jemayev up, and Jemayev saying, I was only following Daniluk. Wickline again winning the drawback. Rogers quickly over the left side. Doe up top. Rogers has traffic. His shot blocker saved there. Rebound onto the wall. And can they keep it in? Puck towards the line. Delaware pushed it just over. River Dragons quickly back in. Wickline. Cross ice feed. Rogers. 6 seconds in the power play. Feeds it down low. Backdoor feed in front. Here's a chance. Jemayev battling away. Can't get a shot. Puck still free in front. They score. Austin Doe picks up the loose puck. Fires it over the sprawling goaltender Nitchenko. We're tied at three. The scramble was on in front of the net. And the puck just far enough out of the reach of the goaltender that he couldn't pull it in to try to get a whistle. An even strength goal, but Austin Doe patiently waiting on the left side of the goal crease. When it came to him, made no mistake. Doe buries his 15th of the year. River Dragons now trying to get the puck out of their own end. Here's Storjahan dumping it in under a minute to go in regulation. Now tied up at three. Puck to the right point. Frazier holding it in. So the River Dragons have gone from let's just tie this game to hey, how about one more here in the remaining 43 seconds. Here they come. Storjahan in from the slot. A shot. Nitchenko the save, and he holds on. Jemayev picks up an assist. As does Aldworth. Quick line, out with Jemayev and Aldworth again. Greco and Lavella on the points, 35.4 seconds to go. Draws one back between the D and out of the zone. Lavella turning it back in. Here's Wickline, keeping it in the right side corner. Jemayev into the slot, looking for Aldworth. Aldworth hooks it towards the front of the net. Puck stays behind. Around it goes off the mid of Wickline. Wickline on it, chips it to the point. Lavella, his drive, that one goes to the glass. Down for the right point is Greco, trying to keep it alive. Sends it, a kick right back to Greco in front. Oh, Nitchenko recovered in time to make the save. He was looking over his right shoulder. The puck was on his left, and Greco just couldn't get the shot away fast enough. Oh, so close. It just took a kick off a stanchion right to Greco, but it just wouldn't settle. 7.2 seconds to go. Tied at three. One back to the point. Greco flips it into the corner. Wickline centers. That one tipped away by Wilson, and that's it. Overtime. Wow, getting your money's worth out of this one here this afternoon. So, it is 3-on-3 in overtime, a maximum of 5 minutes. It is sudden death. If we do not have a winner in overtime, we go to a shootout, which we did on Friday night. Took four rounds, but that one was decided in favor of Delaware. But 3-on-3 OT, Delaware's absolutely stolen at least a point here. Stolen it. This is a different Delaware Thunder hockey team. They are just, they're different. All right, 3-on-3. We'll start with Petrantonio and Doe. Rogers on defense. Milushkin tried to jump early. He'll have to go reset. And the draw one back by Wilson. Milushkin playing it over, and now back to Wilson. Daniluk wheeling in his own end with it. He'll curl all the way behind the net. Watched by Doe. Milushkin on the right side, cuts high, leaves it off. Daniluk at the far dot with a wrist shot. Colgan the save, and he elects to hold it long enough to get the whistle. Colgan thought the better of it. He wanted to play it, and he's trapped it, I would say, long enough to get that whistle with a faceoff to his left. 31 seconds into the overtime. We're tied up at three. River Dragons win the draw, and here's Rogers to the right side. Austin Doe, Rogers going to the net. Rogers backhand and just getting a piece of it was Nitchenko. Great pass in front from Doe, and he just spilled down behind the net. Took everybody a minute to untangle back there. River Dragons trying to get a quick change here. They change out the forwards at least. Grant Mentis cutting into his right. Try to get a shot away, and he's hooked off it by Aldworth. Now goes back to it. Grant Mentis looking to slide it in front. Picked off again by Aldworth, and Aldworth pushing ahead with the Wickline. Here they go, 2-on-1. Wickline in. Aldworth tips, and that one is knocked away to the corner. Aldworth pulls it out in front off his skates. Leaves it for LaBelle. Right side his wrist shot. Nitchenko a glove save, and he holds on. 1:19 into overtime. Tied at three, River Dragons and Thunder. Wickline had four last night, Aldworth had four last night. Wickline had three assists in last night's game. You know that you'd like to find a little of that magic here. Instead, it's a chance for Delaware, but that's pushed away. Nice job, LaBelle, on the stick check. And now LaBelle, pressured, spins away from Milushkin back into his own end. 1:40 gone in the overtime, tied at three. Aldworth onto the left side. Wickline off his skates, couldn't control the puck. Daniluk all the way back into the River Dragon zone. Off-angle chance, puck free in front, set up the middle, and that was not kept in. Columbus a chance to change here. Wickline tired at the end of a shift. Instead, he didn't even get it deep. Instead, back the other way, here's Milushkin walking in. Chance in front, and a save by Colgan as he took it away. Played the rebound out. and it's turned over. There's a shot, and that missed on the blocker side. Columbus needs a line change. Here's Aldworth up, though. He's got speed, trying to cut in. Aldworth, backdoor feed, shot over top of the net by Storjahan. Wilson out with it. Aldworth trying to get to the bench. LaBelle will as well. Unfortunately, Delaware also tired. They get a change after a long shift. 2:17 and counting left in this possible 5-minute 3-on-3 overtime. We're tied at 3. Shots are 56-28 for Columbus. Here they go up the left side. Delaware cutting in. Delaney ridden off behind the net. Ends up in the far corner. Bumped off by Frazio. Behind the goal, it's Wolf. Wolf at the far side. Delaney in the high slot backing up. Lost it. And it goes out to center. Kelly pursuing. Couldn't get to Daniluk in time. He's back into the right side. Daniluk driving in the back. Can't save Colgan. Rebound is cleared to the near corner. Daniluk on it. Feeds it up top. Delaney lets it go. Tipped down in front. Now back the other way, River Dragons trying to break quickly up 2-on-2. Storjahan in with Kelly. Storjahan to the left side. Behind the net. Curls, wraparound attempt right through the crease. Vanelli down into the left side corner. Keeping the play alive. Adam Vanelli near side. Turnaround chance. That one is tipped over top. Storjahan to the left half wall, and now it's pushed back down the ice. Vanelli will go back for it. River Dragons get a couple new forwards out there. 1 minute to go in the overtime, tied at 3. Here's Vanelli. Left side. Ahead to Costello. He's got King with him. Costello on the wing. Left side with a wrist shot. Missed the net. Costello on the right half wall. Steps around one. Looking for a little bit of room. He'll back it up to the right point. 44 seconds to go in OT. King at the line. Costello down low, walks in front, shot, save made, rebound is held. Nijenko again with a big time stop. Face off will be to the right of the Delaware Thunder cage. 36.7 seconds to go in overtime. And again, Colgan is having trouble with that right pad. Maybe it's the left pad. He's working on something over there. I can't really tell what he's got going on. But maybe that's by design. Now Jack Barry out there to try to help him work on whatever he's working on. Austin Doe also getting a dry pair of mitts in the process. Doe, Petrantonio, and Rogers await the faceoff in the Delaware end. Colgan is back in net. Petrantonio, Doe keeping it in. Leaving off at a space left side to Rogers. 30 seconds to go in overtime. Petrantonio, wrist shot, missed the net. Right side, Petrantonio takes a look at the right point. Looking for Doe. Doe curling in the high slot. Doe to his left, shot, and a right pad save. Doe on the rebound in the corner. 17 seconds to go. Rogers in the left side. Rogers spins back down to the corner. Stops, looks, feeds Doe. 8 seconds. Doe up top of the backhand. Crowd wants him to shoot. Doe curls. Time winding down. Puck in front. Hit Rogers. Shootout. The River Dragons cannot find the answer in overtime. And just the way we did Friday, we do on Sunday. That is go to a shootout tied at 3. So the way the shootout works, if you're new to this, it's the best of 3. Each team will get 3 opportunities, unless, of course, 3 aren't needed. If, after 3 rounds, we are tied, then we will go round by round to decide a winner. Yeah. 59 shots for the River Dragons. That ties the season high. 30 shots for the Thunder. And it'll be Colgan and Nitschenko facing off head-to-head in the shootout here. Colgan's a big guy, covers up a lot of net. Grant Mentis is going to be the first shooter out. The former River Dragon has two in this game. His second and third of the season. And he will pick the puck up and weave wide to the right. Colgan way out to greet him. Grant Mentis into the backhand forehand, tried to tuck it, and he cannot get it to go. The long left leg of Brandon Colgan had him running out of room. Now it's Jacob Kelly out for the River Dragons. Kelly at the dot, ready to go. He'll go way wide to the left, cutting in on goal, shot, score! Kelly finds room along the ice. He beats Nitschenko low, and the River Dragons take a 1-0 lead, one round into the shootout. Now Houston Wilson, ready to shoot for Delaware. He'll go wide right. Cutting in, Wilson to the backhand, forehand, and he dribbles it wide. Colgan got a piece of it. And now Columbus with a chance for Lane King. King can end it right here. King will go right up the middle now. Weave left in over the line to the dot. King, stick handling slowly in front of shot and a glove save. Nitschenko. So we continue on. 1-0 River Dragons through two rounds. Now Danila Milushkin will get his chance. He must score to keep it going. If Colgan makes a save, the game's over. Milushkin to his right. He'll walk it in from the dot. Milushkin cutting in front, backhand, forehand. He scores. So Milushkin gives his team life. But now, Alexander Jemayev can end it. Jemayev up the middle, now to the right. The left-hand shot to the hash marks. Fake shoots, and he's shut down by the right pad. And through three rounds, we are tied at one. That means now sudden death round by round. I believe that is Weber out to shoot. No, it's Venstrom. Venstrom working his way into the backhand forehand. He sent that one to the glass. So now again, a chance for the River Dragons to win it. Thomas Aldworth will be the shooter. Bottom of round four. Aldworth moving in quickly. He will come in forehand and rip it wide on the glove side. So now, for the Thunder, it's going to be number 23, T.J. Delaney. Round five. We are tied at one. In this shootout, Delaney to the right, almost lost the puck. Now he's got it, walks in a shot. Colgan the save. Solid stop there with a pad. And again, River Dragons. Potential game winner for Alex Storjahan. Storjahan will bring it straight down the ice. Storjahan, left side, backhand, and he has stopped. Tried to chip it back, stick side. So, five rounds in, 1-1. Round number six. So, Daniluk will shoot now for Delaware. He will weave in wide. Not a lot of speed as he walks in, shoots, and the save made by Colgan. The has that one in the gear. Let's see who Columbus elects to send out now. It's going to be Adam Benelli. Benelli off the dot at center. He'll move in wide to the right. Cutting in, looking in front, to the backhand, he scores! Adam Benelli wins it in the shootout! The River Dragons will take their 2 points in round number six. And now Lane King is getting into a fracas all the way back in the Thunder end of things. He's being escorted out by the linesman. And boy, these two teams are coming together right now at center ice. The officials trying to get in there. There is an awful lot of distaste after this series and a lot of talking. Grant Mentis is over there. They're trying to get Delaware off the ice. It's funny how some of the players know each other and they talk and they're buddies in the offseason. Then there's the other kind of coming together and talking it over, which usually involves pushing and shoving and a few punches. Still having trouble getting Delaware off the ice. All right, well, we finally got that sorted out, I think. We'll take a break. When we come back, it's Pepsi Postgame Showtime. Weight Cleaners, three stars of the game up next. Out of town scoreboard brought to you by Zelmo Zip and more coming your way in just a moment. Back with more. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Is that the sound of an ooey gooey cheesy crunchy slice of P-I-Z-Z-A? Obviously. But as good as that sounds, we think it can get even better. Oh yeah, that's the sound of a freshly opened fizz-filled Pepsi. The only thing that can take this flavor medley of crunchy dough, mouth-watering cheese, and savory sauce to the next level. How about another bite? Pepsi and pizza sound like a match made in heaven and taste even better. Pizza, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-thru and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat-pressed lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
It's time for the Pepsi Postgame Show on the River Dragons Broadcast Network. Tonight's show is brought to you by Pepsi, Air Force Heating and Air, Beam TV, Zelmo Zip-In, and Wade Cleaners. Now, with a recap of tonight's action, here's Tom Callahan.
And time for your three stars of the game brought to you by Wade Cleaners. Third star tonight, Thomas Aldworth. Second star, Austin Doe. And we'll get just... we're back just in time to get the crowning of our first star and the post-game interview. Alexander Jemayev, first star of tonight's game. Welcome back, Jemayev. And he will come out and, well, he just scooted right off the ice. Now he's going to come back for his chat with Jaden. Let's send it down. Your weight cleaners, three stars of the game. We'll take a break in the Pepsi postgame show. When we come back, we've got the Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard and a look back at the scoring in this one for you. Stay tuned. More coming your way in just a moment. River Dragons win a 4-3 in a shootout. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled to perfection burger sounds amazing, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang. Burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavors makes every bite of lettuce, every sesame seed on the bun, and every sip of that crisp, refreshing, ice-cold cola a journey to Foodtopia. Burgers, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-thru and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
Complete Tire and Service, located at 3109 Victory Drive in Columbus, is the perfect place to take care of everything your vehicle needs. From preventive maintenance to alignments, brakes, oil changes, and more, your friends at Complete Tire and Service have you covered. Need tires? Buy three, get one free for passenger vehicles. Call 706-321-8133 to set up your appointment. 321-8133. Complete Tire and Service on the web at ctstires.com. In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We're proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passion.
The post game show, Tom Callahan here with you in the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Harvey Lumber serving the community for over 150 years. River Dragons 4-3 in a shootout tonight over the Delaware Thunder. And man, this one not without its animosity. That is for sure. Let's take a look right now at our Zelmo's Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard. There was only one other game going on in the FPHL tonight, and that one has gone final as the Columbus River Dragons, we mentioned, win 4-3 in a shootout here, and Watertown ends up winning in overtime 2-1 over the Elmira Mammoth. In the NHL, let's see what we have going on right now to wrap up this Sunday schedule. Blackhawks with a 3-1 lead up over the Toronto Maple Leafs. Then you got the Jets 2-1 over the Devils early, well, late in the first, I should say, of that one. Blue Jackets Coyotes coming up at 8:30 Eastern. Finals from earlier today, Wild 4-3 over the Predators. Senators 7-2 over the Blues. Avalanche in overtime 6-5 over the Oilers. And your Daytona 500 winner, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Logano, Bell, Buescher, and Bowman round out the top five. All right, that's the Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard. When we come back, we'll wrap things up with the scoring on this one. And the River Dragons 4-3 in a shootout over the Delaware Thunder. And pick up another 2 points here in the season standings. We'll return with more in just a moment. This is the Pepsi Postgame Show, Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain is your trusted plumber in Columbus and beyond. We go the extra mile to show up on time, diagnose your situation quickly, and get to the root of the problem. Blue Frog is here to deliver the right solution the first time. And we're available 24/7 because plumbing emergencies don't keep office hours. Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain. Less mess, less stress. On the web at bluefrogplumbing.com or call 706-887-6433.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
Hydrolife Therapy at Old Town is your one-stop recovery shop to get you back to 100%. With IV therapy treatments, cryotherapy, and compression therapy all under one roof, Hydrolife treatments are packed with nutrients to increase energy and boost your immune system. Join the IV League today for the most affordable way to feel better, look better, and start accomplishing more. Online at HydrolifeTherapy.com/Columbus. Hydrolife Therapy. Start living your best life.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon fiberglass and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
Let's go!
Back here at the Pepsi Post Game Show, Tom Callahan here with you up in the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Thanks for joining me, everybody. Time to recap the scoring in a 4-3 shootout win for the Columbus River Dragons. No scoring in the first period to tell you about, so into the second we go, where the River Dragons scored a pair of goals 11 seconds apart. It started at 8:09 with Josh Petrantonio's 11th from Austin Doe and Kyle Underwood. Kirk Underwood. I did that to him earlier. It was funny. I was listening to NASCAR while I was writing out my roster earlier, and I actually wrote Kyle Underwood on the roster that I was writing. Anyway, Kirk Underwood with the assist on Petrantonio's goal, his 11th of the season there, and at 8:09. So, and boy, it's so good to see that line getting it back together. Again, Doe and Petrantonio really finding the chemistry again, and boy, you can only hope that they really catch fire here down the stretch. 11 seconds later, it's Alexander Jemayev scoring his 10th of the year from Wickline and Aldworth. And Jemayev, good to see him back in the lineup. Connects on the backdoor feed here, cross crease. And you know what? Aldworth likes to shoot the puck, but he can also pass it as well. Delivers on that one. And the River Dragons quickly out in front, 2-0. But the Thunder battled back. At 14:38, it was Ole Venstrom, his 5th of the year from Milushkin. And then Marquise Grant-Mentis scored his first of two on the night at 17:47 from Wolf and Delaney. That was the end of the second period scoring, tied at 2. And in the third at 7:45, it's Grant-Mentis again. This time Venstrom the only assist on the goal. And now Delaware is up 3-2, headed down the stretch. The River Dragons had a late power play chance they did not capitalize on. The River Dragons, in fact, 0-for-6 in the power play in this game. But shortly after the power play expires, Austin Doe rides to the rescue. 18:32, time of the goal. Doe's 15th from Jemayev and Aldworth. And the goal mouth scramble that happens in front, the puck finally pops out to a patient Doe on the back door. He's following the play. You see him creeping in, looking, finds that loose puck and puts it in to tie the game at 3. That would push it to overtime and then to a shootout. And that shootout went 6 rounds as the River Dragons get a goal from Kelly in the first round. And then Milushkin scores in the third to keep Delaware alive. We would then go round by round to determine a winner all the way to round number 6. And that is where Adam Vanelli comes up with the game winner. Is Vanelli off the dot with it, took it wide to the right-hand side, walked in, and a little backhand flick, and it goes. Game over, River Dragons, for the first time this season, win a shootout, 4-3, your final. Shots in the game by period for Delaware, 9 in the first and second, 7 in the third, 5 in overtime for 30. For the River Dragons, it was 12-19-24 in the third period, 4 in overtime, 60 shots on goal. That is a new season high for the River Dragons. Power plays, Columbus 0 for 6, Delaware 0 for 2. So that'll do it for our scoring wrap here in our look inside the numbers. That'll also close it out in the Pepsi postgame show as the Columbus River Dragons, they pull it out of the fire. That was not an easy win for Columbus, but they managed to get it, and in doing so, that is their 30th win of the season. And now the River Dragons have, after getting through this 3-3, and now find themselves 36-3, now have only one game coming up next weekend, and that is Friday night in Mississippi against the Seawolves. And so from a heavy weekend to a light weekend, and just a Friday night road trip for the River Dragons, and then they will head into the teeth of March and April. There's only really about 7 weeks left in the regular season here in the FPHL, and the River Dragons have a lot of work facing them here, a lot of way yet to go, but they've now clinched a postseason berth and now just look to lock up the division and hopefully number one spot overall in the league, because if they do, that guarantees them home ice no matter who they face in the Commissioner's Cup playoffs. I want to say thank you to my broadcast crew for getting us through. It's been a busy weekend here. Everybody's tired, and they've done a great job. Thank you, everybody. We appreciate your efforts. And also want to say thank you to the fans and our great sponsors here of River Dragons Hockey. We couldn't do it without you. Thank you so much for being a part of things. One more time, your final score in a shootout. The River Dragons, a big 4-3 win over the Delaware Thunder. This is Tom Callahan saying goodnight from the Harvey Lumber Press Box, and thank you for being a part of Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Dragons Broadcast Network. Tonight's show was brought to you by Pepsi, Air Force Heating and Air, Beam TV, Zelmo Zip-In, and Wade Cleaners. All rights to this broadcast are reserved by the Columbus River Dragons and PMB Broadcasting for the private use of their audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, or other distribution or the descriptions or accounts of this game are expressly prohibited without the written consent of Ignite Sports and Entertainment and PMB Broadcasting. This has been a presentation of the Columbus River Dragons Hockey Club.
Back to Columbus's Real Rock.